Hello and welcome to episode 41 of the Terminus Podcast for the weeks of December 12th, 2015.
Woo.
I am your dispatcher Ellis, otherwise known as Train Man. With me, my engineers are Weibold, Jader, and Milky.
Yes.
And with us this week, our guest brakeman is Kevon.
Hello.
And before we get to, well, basically the second attempt at what we did last time, the train will terminate. At this station.
Okay, currently we are staring at a screen.
With a man leaning out of the window of a locomotive.
I don't know. Tell if it's like that because I can't see. Anyway, today we're going to be watching Kevon run the Iron Horseman route because so many people have been requesting it on Ellis's build series that we decided to do it here because that might be a very good system of doing these sort of things.
I'm still going to do run sessions every 10 episodes, but this is...
Because you guys want more operation and seeing... Because you obviously, in your own sessions, you can't encompass all of the route. This will show other stuff.
So Kevon's going through Douglas right now.
Yes, this is Douglas at the far east.
You can't, Weibold, you could join his stream, couldn't you?
That would entail starting Steam, which... There is the distinct possibility that if I start Steam, everything goes to hell.
Oh, okay.
It's not a guarantee, but it is a very distinct possibility.
I didn't know Steam hated you so much.
Steam hates me because it's ported to Mac really, really badly.
Thanks,
it's not so much that Steam hates me, it's that the computer hates Steam.
Yeah. I could gather that.
Anywho,
wait a minute. Did I not get rid of the stuff from last week? No, I definitely... Last week, did we talk about the mystery station?
Yeah, I guess.
I think so.
Let me go check. Oh, someone take the thing. I'm going to go check on and make sure that we did.
I am clenching the thing.
Oh. Reluctantly crashed at the starting line. Anyways, no, somebody, news, go, what's going on? Jader, is the EBT alive?
No.
Didn't think so. No. Alright. Weibold, you actually, there is something going on up in your neck of the woods, isn't there, involving a ghost town?
Yes, there is. Didn't I talk about this last week?
I don't think it was going on last week.
Oh. Well, it was. It's just that I've caught wind of it pretty recently. It's not a super big thing, and they... Well, anyway, there's a group out of Silverton, Colorado, at the far north end of the Durango and Silverton, that has basically applied for and been granted permission to rebuild a railroad called the Silverton Northern, which was a short line that ran out of Silverton to a local ghost town called Howardsville.
Well, I mean, it wasn't a ghost town then.
It died around the turn of the century.
It's not like they built the railroad to,
build
a, ghost town.
To a ghost town. They didn't build it to a ghost town, but it very quickly was financially unstable. And hang on, I'll go into that in a minute because it's completely off topic. But it does need to be addressed.
Oh dear.
Not necessarily here though. Maybe it can wait. But Silverton Northern, they laid like 200 feet of track or something like that in the latter half of November, and then winter happened. So, yeah, they're kind of stuck. I don't really know why they waited until now to do it, and if they were forced to wait until now, why they didn't wait until after the snow, because it's winter, and the tracks that they've laid are now buried under several feet of snow, and they're not going to see them again until May, so...
It happens.
It happens, but really...
I mean, obviously, they were thinking very far ahead.
Apparently. But, so that's that. Silverton Northern, I don't know what equipment they will run. Currently, they have the Casey Jones rail bus, which is ex-Silverton Northern. It was used as an ambulance.
Wee-oo.
rather, somewhat unnervingly, it was used as an ambulance to run on this short line between the mines in Howardsville and Silverton so that they could get people and keep them from, you know, dying.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, the engine shed of the Silverton Northern is still there in Silverton. It's I think, a two-stall shed. It's currently where 315 is based out of. So either they will have to move, or in another arrangement will be struck up, or they could even start operating this branch line. Additionally, they have a coach that they're going to be restoring next year. They have a bobber caboose for Silverton Northern, and they have an XD and RGW boxcar.
Okay.
And that's it. They don't have a steam engine besides possibly 315, and frankly, I don't know where they're going to get one unless by 40.
That'd be nice.
Or one of our Shays. Get them out of the museum. They're fun to look at, but it hurts knowing that they work fully and they just sit there and rust. It's just not, you know, they could be doing so much more, and it feels really inefficient to have them there. Plus, it makes switching it makes switching hard. I'll talk about that in later, though.
Yeah, I'm sure Sally has a few choice words that she's used before to describe the situation. Yeah. Anyways,
yeah.
I don't believe I did talk about this on the last podcast, and the reason being is because I can't find the link to it that I would have put in the cargo. So, to begin, there is a station, there is a subway station in New York City, that no one is quite sure whether or not it ever existed. It's called 76th Street Station. What was that?
Having your phone on during the podcast.
That's
a,
give him a strike. Give him a strike.
I have like 5 phones.
Give him another strike.
Alright, 2.
Get a strike for that.
You're supposed to have your phone off.
Anyways.
Or at least on
vibrate. There are. Or at least on vibrate. There are a set of tracks. They're at a Lucid Ave station on the ANC line in New York City. There are a set of layup tracks below the active A line. Now, they dead end. There are 4 tracks, so 2 local tracks and 2 express tracks, that dead end at a concrete wall. I don't know why. There is a yard nearby. This underground yard also has 2 tracks that lead in the general direction of this area, and they dead end at a cinder block wall. I mean, naturally, having tracks that don't go anyplace isn't particularly outlandish. It happens, especially when you're building subways and you have a lot of plans for expansion and whatnot. But these, not only are the tracks built directly up to the walls, but there are even signals facing the wrong way. As in, there are signals and switchboards and stuff prepared, fully prepared for trains to come out of the wall and continue driving into the main system.
It'd be like the Ghostbusters train, just...
Yeah, exactly. But let me see if I can... There's even a switchboard, which shows how, which shows the arrangement of the railroads, or the arrangement of the tracks and the platforms under there. And they've tried to figure it out. The MBTA, or the MTA, rather, they took a drill to the concrete wall. And it started leaking. So they plugged it up immediately. And now if you go over to the cinder block wall and chip through it, you just get soil. Just dirt. And lots of dirt. So, I don't know. Was there a station that got buried? You know, some people insist that they have been, and some people insist that it never existed at all. And even the Metropolitan Transit Authority, the MTA, is saying, we don't think there's a station there. But nobody's quite sure. I can,
Come on, I feel like you're gonna run out of steam.
Give him steam.
You're running at full throttle. the entire... Do you have the blower on?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I was going
to
say.
I'm going to point out to our enterprising viewers, I'm going to bring up a picture of this area and point out exactly where it is for any of those, for any of you viewers who have been to the city or live in or near the city and are familiar with 76th Street Station, Grant Avenue, Elucid Avenue, and Pitkin Yard. The one of the oddest things is that the subway line actually jukes to avoid the area where this station would be. You know, in order to connect to an elevated line, which still exists, because they were demolishing the rest of it, so they connected the elevated to the underground and built the Grand Avenue station, instead of continuing through where 76th Street Station would be. But they left all of the other tracks in place, and they are still in place. It's just one of these... one of the railroading mysteries. Unfortunately, I feel like I expended most of the conversation on it, talking about it just in general with everybody here. And I went on a very long wild goose chase. Or not particularly long, but I went on a wild goose chase with Weibold trying to find any sort of evidence regarding this, and we didn't get anything.
Nope.
It brought us back to the same source that we had originally, and the only source, in inverted commas, that...
was an April Fool's
joke.
Yeah,
exactly. The only main thing is was an April Fool's joke. Everything else either links back to there or is very little information at all.
Hmm.
So. A lot of this... This came to light because of an AMA, an Ask Me Anything on Reddit, the NYC Rail subreddit, where someone who is... I mean, I'm going to call him this, but don't... It's not a detractor. He is a self-proclaimed subway expert. And, frankly, he answered all these effing questions. So, I'm going to go with him. He's a subway expert.
Let's get him on the podcast.
Why would that be a bad thing?
Well, because generally when you say self-proclaimed, it's like...
Well...
I'm an expert.
I'm the best at everything.
I'm an underwater basket weaver.
What?
Nothing.
Anyways.
Okay.
But, you know, check this out. Oh, it's a lot of people asking questions about the frequency of trains, about weird things like door holding. How do you know whether the N or the Q leaves first going northbound at 34th Street, Herald Square? And he goes into very detail, and he talks about whichever train has holding lights will be held and the other train will leave, blah, 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 blah. It was incredible for me, and I'm not particularly versed with the New York City subway system, and so I would find myself going back and forth to a map, a very large map, called 469 stations, 846 miles, which is a just basic overview map of the entire subway system in a sort of in transit map fashion. With all tracks included. Even the ones that are out of service. So anyways. That's almost everything out of the MTA now. The other thing, during Hurricane Sandy, the Metropolitan Transit Authority, the New York City Subway in particular, lost a lot of assets. For example, I've mentioned previously the brand new station that was the terminating point on the one line, which was going to replace the old Ferry Loops, South Ferry Loops, was built, completed, opened for service, 3 months later, completely destroyed. And it's still out of service. So, you know, it's the kind, they lost a lot.
The difficulty with having trains underground.
Yes, exactly, and below the water table
on,
as well.
On the ocean. The difficulty of putting anything underground near the sea, especially things that are, you know...
electrical in nature.
Delicate, mobile, and electric.
Speaking of, and just like that, the turnstiles that you use to pass through to enter the subway and to leave, you know, swipe your card...
The things that they have at amusement parks,
exactly.
For those who don't take New York City subway frequently.
or, you know, subways in general, a lot of those kinds of things will typically have turnstiles of some description. But, you know, you swipe your card, it generally has like three spokes. If you've ever been to Disney World, they're all over the place, you know, and, you know, it goes click a click and you walk through and you're going to the ride or whatever.
Again, it's usually main gate of theme parks is where these are.
Yeah, exactly. And, well, they haven't been built for the New York City subway in about 20 years. And Hurricane Sandy destroyed almost all of the ones they had in reserve. And the rest of them...
I thought they got some...
What?
Go ahead.
And the rest of them are being used for the Second Avenue line, which is a very large extension that is being worked on currently. So they need to resurrect the designs and start building new ones, because a great many were destroyed. It's just the sort of interesting thing, you know. You think about, well, obviously with the narrow gauge, or with Steam Heritage in general, you can't get the parts for these things anymore.
Yeah.
Because people don't make them, because most people don't use them. People still use turnstiles. Mm-hmm. I don't know why they decided to stop making them.
Is it just they don't make turnstiles in general? They don't make the type that New York City Subway uses?
They don't make the type that the Subway uses anymore. The Subway stopped asking for them, and I think the facility that made them shut down after that.
Why not just get turnstiles from somewhere else?
Because they wouldn't be compatible with the system that's already in place. You know, and I'm not sure what the nuances of it are, but I'm sure that it's, you know, different sorts of codecs and this, that, and the other. It's not exactly... We built the last turnstiles approximately 20 years ago. Almost every electronic component has really gone obsolete since then. Using the original, even the company that made the turnstiles metal cabinets is now out of business. Using the original plans, cubing of the metal frames made to order, its manufacturing facility in Tullahoma, Tennessee, with stockpiled discontinued electronics, was able to build the technology for the fare card readers. So they had to build 78 new ones. Because most people don't use like tokens or anything anymore. They use swipe cards. And then most people have evolved past swipe cards at this point. And
straight up using their phone.
Yeah. You know, even that, or, you know, just like a touch card or something like that. And I don't even know. I don't know what they're trying to do, but they figured, oh, we have enough, and we're going to make the switch to something else in the future, so we don't need more turnstiles. I don't know. Also, because it's been 25 years since the MTA actually opened a new station, other than the one that got flooded. So, I don't even know. And, you know...
They're just having a rough time at this point.
What?
They're just having a rough time.
Yeah.
No!
Yeah.
No.
Sorry, not about that. Anybody... Okay, I'll talk about that later, maybe.
But anyways, check out the AMA, most certainly, if you're interested in obsolete electronics. The return styles.
The return styles.
Wow.
Boo.
You're getting a point for that.
I know, I figured.
I got it.
Alright.
Okay.
Anyways. That's and then of course the mysterious 76th Street Station that nobody really knows exists or not. Once again.
Spooky.
Yeah.
It's like the hidden Russian railway system that they have. Subway system that they have.
Wait, what?
Russia has, like, two separate subways. One was in case, Russia got nuked or something.
Something, something, Metro 2033.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was a game. All right. Anyways.
That was a game.
Okay, who else has got news? Hey, Jada, what's going on with your stuff?
Okay, the Midwest Railway Preservation Society is running their Santa trains.
Santa trains!
Which, I don't know if they actually go anywhere. I think they just kind of go up and back through the little yard they have.
Oh.
Is it Steam?
No. They have, okay. They have an... Well, no, it's technically Steam because they have an RS3. It's
honorary Steam engine. Got it.
Yeah. Yeah. Four Wayne's running their ascent trains. Age of Steam, are they doing anything?
Probably not.
Oh, wait. Let me find the thing.
What thing?
Just give me a moment.
Just give me a minute.
Uh-oh. He's going the distance.
I'm just watching Jader, or not Jader, I'm friggin' elf. I'm watching Gavon. Like, he's not, you're not in Jader's portion yet. But you're getting there. Also, yes, you seem to be going fairly well.
Yeah, for now.
For now, yeah.
Yeah, until you flood one of the engines or blow one up or...
No, Kevon, are you going to change... you should change power at, like, Albany.
I don't have power. I know where to change power.
Damn it.
Okay.
See, that's what I would do. Just change power to go through the gorge.
I'm on Davenport.
Oh.
Well, yeah, but are you going to go up and over, or are you going to go down and through?
Up and over.
Okay.
Oh.
But then I'll go down and through.
You should change power at Summit. Oh, wait, you can't.
There's that... No. There's nothing at Summit.
Okay, yeah. Yes, the Age of Steamrun House has acquired from the Mid-Continent Railway Museum, Woodward Iron Number 41. It's U10O.
Oh.
No, it's not. I don't think it's Russian.
Oh,
honorary Russian.
Honorary Russian. That's a good logic.
I mean, it might be Russian, but I don't know.
Just maybe.
Send a picture of it.
Yeah, well,
I'm not really sure if I can.
Cause this son of a gun.
No, I can't really. I'm not really sure if I can because it. Everything I've found about this engine, it's in the Age of Steamrun House Facebook group, which is a closed group. So I don't know if I'm.
Oh no.
Are you not supposed to be in it?
Well, no, I joined.
No, you. Yeah.
Okay.
It's the same way with most of the information.
I forgot. I forgot. They're really reclusive, aren't they?
Yeah, they kind of are.
Here. They have the. They have a video of it getting, of a guy pacing it.
Is it running? I can't.
Well, no. They just put it on a flat car behind a freight train.
Oh, okay.
Oh, is this it? Oh my God. Oh, I'd be very nervous watching that.
Watching what?
There's a picture of it. He's right. They literally put it on a flat car and tacked it to the back of a freight train. And it's going over a bridge, and it just looks like it has such a high center of gravity. And it's going over this little bridge over a lot of water.
It's first they don't... See, that's where a caboose would make sense.
But no, it's not Russian.
No, that's where a caboose would make sense, so someone's watching it.
But yeah, no, that's not Russian.
Yeah, no, it's too...
It doesn't...
Reference to last week...
Yeah.
What?
The caboose thing.
Oh.
Yeah.
Or, yeah.
Caboose.
Caboose
does.
They're doing their thing. Hocking Valley, I'm pretty sure they're running their Santa trains.
Woohoo!
Hey,
kitty. Oh, gotta buy
some. Railway Museum, I think. They're running their trolleys.
Trolley?
Heard it yesterday.
You can do it, come on. I believe.
Don't know if it's anything.
I'm trying.
And then yesterday, I actually did a little bit of rail fanning.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. So it was at the Central Ohio Model Railroad Club's open house running stuff. And, you know, I put my train back in the staging yard, decided to take a break. Went outside, heard a train coming up the hill. There were two CSX Trash 9s with a loaded coal train heading north.
Trash 9s?
Yeah. Wow. Yoki can elaborate. Okay.
What the heck is Yoki's going on?
Yoki's dead.
No one can watch too.
We're creeping on the guy in the... Oh my God. Come on.
Yeah, sorry.
See? Why do you have a caboose right behind the engines? Oh, wait, no, it's the pusher.
Yeah.
Kevon, you're slowing down. J1.
Why is the pusher backwards then?
I am very.
Well, it's
the
not.
Pusher isn't backwards. What do you mean?
Okay, well then, how is the caboose at the end of the train and behind the pusher?
Kevon, that's how. Or, Weibel, that's how. That's how that works.
Yeah. That's how
they
it
would,
works.
They would. They would oftentimes.
Oh, okay. I see. So the pusher is between the train and the caboose.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. So okay. If something happened, they wouldn't ram through the caboose and kill everyone in there.
You said. You said pusher. And you said it was behind the engine, so I pictured the helper on the back of the caboose pushing it backwards.
What? It happens.
Like, how does that make sense?
Why?
No. And then, about 5-10 minutes later, an NS empty coal train, I missed the engines, came south. And then I heard maybe 2 or 3 trains, one of them was inside running stuff. Like, the building kind of shook, and I barely heard it. Now, I wanted to run out and see what it was, but I couldn't because it was running my train.
Aw.
Jeez.
Yeah. Aww. And that's it for me.
Woo.
Alright. What's, what's going on with your stuff, Oki?
Okay, you know how there's, Prairie City was the beginning of the Sumter Valley, pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
What, Sumter?
Like, no, Prairie City.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
And the depot is still there to this day, and you can go to it. It's a nice little museum with a boxcar in front of it. But anyways, the building is apparently endangered.
Uh-oh.
Dun-dun-dun.
So apparently it's going to get a few grants and get a restoration.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good.
To be honest, just run the Sumter Valley currently up to it. In the new Sumter Valley.
How far is it from the current Sumter Valley track?
Like 30 miles. And the wideway is still there.
There's a lot of track delay, though.
And it's narrow gauge.
That would compared to, say, Bonn.
Well, yeah, but they're not going to do that either. I mean,
no point.
Let's go lay some pipe.
The last words of the DNRGW.
Let's go lay some pipe.
They died
as they lived.
Well, I wasn't going to say that, but I was going to say something about they died living the dream.
Jeez.
The American dream.
Or would it be that with an I?
What?
Hang.
Do those things have running numbers, come on? Like,
C.
Okay, good. Are you just stopped waiting for steam pressure to accumulate?
Yes.
Okay.
And kinda.
Are you stuck?
Yes, I'm stuck.
God damn it, Kevon.
Okay. Well,
Kevon turns on easy mode. I like how they changed the name from DCC to easy mode. It's like, feel bad.
Is that really what they did?
Yes.
But it's not Also, it's not realistic, to be honest.
That is hilarious.
Easy mode.
What do you mean it's
that
not
is hilarious. That just made my day. That is fantastic.
Now I feel bad.
Good.
Feel bad.
Easy mode. Welcome to RB, you arcade scrub.
Jesus Christ.
I have 3J1s. They should be fine, but no. Trains physics.
Standards.
Well, I mean, standards I feel like it becomes difficult for a single person to run 3 locomotives at once with any sort of efficiency.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, think about it. Let's have one person run a locomotive that takes 2 people to run. No. Let's have him run 3 of those locomotives.
Or 20 tanks. Anyways, there's something happening in the politics of railroading, Milky.
Oh, no.
Yeah, there is.
So, it's CPNS.
Yeah, CPNS.
Sipness.
Am.
What's CPNS?
CPNS. So after, of course, after CP tried to acquire NS, and NS was like, that's not enough money. CP offered them less.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
But then BNSF was like, we'll also lowball you. So
yeah,
how is that going?
Everyone's hopping on NS now for some odd reason.
War.
Yeah, war.
That's not what I said. Anyways, I don't think this is gonna go any farther than CPNS will, to be honest.
Yeah, it's more of a chance than CPNS did.
Would it?
Yeah.
Why would it?
Because you don't have to go through Canadian government, American government deals.
Fair point.
Yeah,
but
the
Canadian government
has a lot.
Was that being constructive to begin with?
Yeah, I don't think that's why NS was like, nah. NS was like, nah, because they think it's a dumb idea and they weren't getting enough money.
Hmm. That's true.
Let me see. I'm going to check something real quick.
I mean, I might be completely wrong in just talking out of my ass, as I usually do, but it just seems like that wouldn't be the issue. That wouldn't be the issue.
Hmm. And they also... They also bring up Union Pacific and CSX in this.
Oh no. UPucks.
They declined the comment, but.
Or
UPucks. They got bought up.
It's a UFO.
I wanna see.
Everybody look! A UFO!
A UFO! Everybody do the flop! Bah!
Damn.
I'm trying to find the I'm trying to find the stock values of BNSF and CP.
CP has the most stock. I think it CP has
That's
is the most profitable company out of all the railroads.
It is the worst.
No, the most profitable.
It is.
Really? Okay. Well, they. Yes. It's obvious they do better than CN, because all CN can do is turn engines over in the rotary.
You know, we haven't looked at that in a while. I was going to post that the other day. Just for, you know, obligatory.
No,
obligatory
what I want to
screw up.
No, what I want to know is have
they put
done
the
it
rotary
again?
Coupler at the wrong end.
Oh, no.
No, have they done it again? That's what I want to know.
Probably. I have a feeling that kind of thing happens... Sadly, far too often with rotary dumpers.
Mm.
Yeah.
And it won't show me the Burlington Northern stock price, but Canadian Pacific stock price is about $123.50 per share.
Hmm.
And
it's actually pretty good.
NS stock price. Let me check. It is.
NS is like.
NS is about $33.50 per share.
Yeah, it's really miserable.
Hold on. Now I've got to check CSX.
I think CSX has the lowest,
yeah,
if I remember.
Yeah, CSX is $25.72.
No surprise.
What about UP?
UP's probably pretty middle of the road.
Yeah.
I'm surprised CP isn't trying to merge with CSX. I mean...
No one does seems like it make more sense.
UP is 77.28.
Damn, son.
No, actually, what's Canadian Pacific? Or Canadian National, rather.
Terrible.
Canadian National Railway stock. 52.
It's upside down.
52.73.
Not bad.
It's not bad, actually.
No.
Just
And the kicker. Pan Am Railways.
Oh,
stock.
No.
Do they even have stock?
I don't know.
It'll give you a negative number.
it's not. It's not showing me how much the stock price is.
It's like, I didn't know you could have that many decimal places.
Apparently they're demolishing one of the big drawbridges somewhere on the Pan Am system and moving the line somewhere else.
God. Yeah.
I was like, guys. Well, it's a multi-use bridge too. It was a road and rail bridge, and so the city just relocated everything to a new bridge.
I see.
I don't know.
I'm back.
Okay.
Oh, it's still private, so I guess they don't have stock. They don't have they don't do that kind of thing. So, anyway. Anyways. We'll see who buys who.
Yeah.
Do you wonder who's he? Who's being true?
I still say Monopoly. The U.S. government doesn't care about Monopoly, so there's that.
Monopoly guy.
Right, Monopoly.
Whose car is parked next door?
And you must be the Monopoly guy. What is...
In suit, Michael Bay explosive.
Yeah.
MLG glasses.
Which takes perfectly into the next thing I have to talk about.
Uh-oh. What is this?
On the story of Braxine, a Portland and Western oil train blew up on the bridge.
Oh, great.
Dear.
Speaking of bridges, kaboom.
Yeah, boom. A truck driver apparently hit the train and triggered a Michael Bay.
Well, I mean, at least they didn't derail.
The truck driver was killed, but Michael Bay happened.
Well,
eight cars.
That sucks to be him, I guess.
Eight cars were damaged.
Mm.
Damaged in inverted commas.
Used
as in they're complete.
Exploded.
There's a picture right under it, and they're not doing so well.
Yeah, they look a little bit toasted.
Were any of the people oil protesters?
No,
yes,
I bet.
Yes, actually, the truck driver. No.
Hello, Akbar! Oh!
Jesus.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, dear. Oh,
Was the train just like... It wasn't moving and he just crashed into it?
No, I think it was moving.
Well, yeah, but... What? How?
Stupid always finds a way.
Yeah. I don't know.
It doesn't even look like it was on a railroad crossing. It's just there.
No, it's like what my history teacher says. When you figure out that... When you finally understand that people are stupid, the world makes a lot more sense.
Mm-hmm.
Stupid... Stupid finds a way. Never. What's the George Carlin quote? Never underestimate the power of stupid people in large groups or something like that.
Yes. That's it.
But,
yep. That's about all there is to be said there.
Yeah.
Nuts.
BNSF spokesman Gus Malona says the railway's main lines were not impacted.
Okay, that's
good.
That's good.
And
so they don't
the
have to
was,
abandon the AI app.
The fire was gotten under control fairly quickly, at least. It's, you know, a shame that the guy died.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how he managed to hit the train in the first place.
He kind of kamikazed into it, so he had...
Yeah, like I said. Al Akbar! Boom! Yeah.
Jesus.
We're awesome. We're terrible people, aren't we?
Yes.
Too soon!
That's why I said I feel bad. And then you're just like, yes. Boom.
We're terrible people. Hello. And I accept that.
Good, except this.
I should feel bad, and I do. But not bad enough to stop.
Wow.
You're bad, and you should feel bad.
You're a terrible person, you should feel bad.
Did I lie at trains more?
Which one, what? Railroad was this?
Portland and Western.
See? That's the crappy P&W.
Ooh.
Like cold water to burned area.
Shots have been
the Providence and Worcester has not exploded in recent memory.
Yeah, but you haven't had a crazy truck type of kamikaze into you.
Well, obviously, because they like us. They must have had it out for you.
See, and this is why the word concern is the name of trains. We have big sweats.
By K&L bonds.
By K&L bonds.
I approve.
I know you do. anyways. And
Kevon, I might have to buy those J1s.
Milky, they weren't the only person who died, I guess.
Yeah. A bicyclist apparently tried to beat the train at the Albany.
Yeah, that's a Darwin Award.
Listen. Yeah. Wait, you know why? Turn. It's because, like, half of the time... Oh, sorry.
What?
Half of the time, 1501 is just there, triggering the railroad crossing, not even moving.
Well, you still gotta look up and see it. Apparently, he didn't notice the train until it was too late. The train was going 30. It's not like it whipped around the corner at 70 miles an hour and, you know...
It wasn't Amtrak. Amtrak just highballs through there.
Well, good thing it wasn't Amtrak, I guess. Well,
otherwise, we wouldn't have a leg to stand on.
Well, I mean, if it didn't say he was going at 30 miles an hour, or if it didn't say the train was going at 30 miles an hour, I wouldn't have made the point that the train was only going at 30 miles an hour.
Mm.
Yeah, that's true.
But...
And you can tell when 1501's webbing up to get going.
Hyde said that weather conditions...
What is 1501?
Yeah, it's like web.
What is it? What is it?
SD7.
Oh.
The last. Apparently, this.
It sounds like a Lego car.
Apparently, this railroad crossing is a thing with killing bicyclists.
Oh yeah, it does.
The railroad crossing is sentient.
Do they not have
bicycle? I want to ride my bicycle now. Funny name, the Shabwell fan at this crossing several times, and
well,
I've seen people go around it.
Don't step out in front of the train, Milky.
I know.
Or just don't be on a bike.
Or don't be on a bike, because that's what the train's target
well,
is.
Well, I mean, both of the fatalities so far have happened on bikes. When in July 2006, rather, in July 2006, when the train hit a car at that intersection, no one was hurt.
You know, it's funny.
Okay. How fast was that one going?
I don't know.
Because if it was going 30, I'll tell you, somebody was hurt.
No, it's like
no, it was a Volvo. The train was hurt.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, sure. That's how that works.
The train could have sustained less damage from striking an M1 Abrams.
Thud.
Oh, wait. Apparently it was a southbound train that approached through the crossing, and then the northbound Union...
No, that was last time.
Oh, crap.
Look, listen, and pay attention. That's all.
So, look, listen, and don't be a moron!
Actually, it might have been Albany and Eastern that hit it. Because I recognize the ancient East name.
I just thought
Stalker.
Of something.
What?
I just thought of something. It says, the test results coming in. It says you are a horrible person.
Yes.
That's what it says, a horrible person. We weren't even testing for that.
You are a horrible
I think I am.
Yeah.
That's what it says, a horrible person. We weren't even testing.
It's a portal reference, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I don't play Portal.
Yeah, well, you should. You know why? Because...
Because tubes.
Yes, actually. Portals, as a matter of fact. Yeah. Anyways, speaking of tubes, boiler tubes. Steamtown is back as Steamtown.
Oh, I thought you were 3985.
What?
I thought you were talking about 3985.
No, 3985 is dead.
Yep.
Anyways.
Oh, yeah.
But
wait,
26
in a moment
is not.
Of silence for 3985.
What?
26 is not dead.
26 is not dead. 26.
Can we have
is...
a moment of silence for
3985?
No.
No.
Wow.
26. Whoa.
we're just going to sentence the steam Nazi to the pit of death.
Yes.
Go send him to Gulag.
Yes. But thankfully. We now have a steam engine out at Steamtown. Probably going to be pulling their Christmas trains if they have them. We're actually getting some entrance fee free days, which are these are ones in the upcoming year. So I'll cover them when I'm done with this. But the little ball with number 26 is running around on its own in the Steamtown Yard. They ran it around for, they ran it around for testing purposes. It is so shiny right now.
I know, it's green.
It will not
like
be
a, it's like an army.
Long.
It's like an army green.
Yeah.
I love it.
I hope they take good care of it.
I hope so too.
I mean, that's the only locomotive they have operating. They better.
Well, it's the only steam locomotive, yeah.
Unless they totally like blow it up, it's good for 15 years.
Sure.
And I look in the background and see 2929, and it makes me sad.
But it's also run by the government, so.
Yeah. Trump subsidized Steamtown.
Okay.
Trump.
Sure.
Or like bankrupt Steamtown. Yes, we're going to build a team one, just
he,
like everyone
he just
wants,
walks in and
it's
like...
a Trump train!
He, wow. He walks in and it's like, you're all fired!
You're all fired. I am your suffering.
That's not good.
I know, it's adorable. I'm glad they have a steam engine. I'm gonna go visit.
Hmm.
And now all of the staff that was working on 26 can be moved to 3713, which we no new update on the on that progress as of today. But you know, we've got a big year coming up. We've got more personnel, and we've got plenty of funding at this point from the donations and whatnot. And so, like I said 2 weeks ago, this year is shaping up to be a big year for 3713. I don't know if we're gonna see the tender decking on it though.
Wait, isn't the tender done?
Yeah, the tender's just hanging out outside. It's done.
Oh.
Tender dunking.
Tender don't dunking. Leave it out in the rain. You know what happened
last
time?
Or else you'll wind up like 3985. You'll just die.
Yeah, so what was behind that exactly?
So there, UP updated their roster for Wyoming, and it said they only had two steam locomotives. 844 and 4014. And 3985 was not on there at all. But also they have... No, it's sad because I have a glow-in-the-dark 3985 shirt, so every time I wear it, it's just in remembrance now.
Yeah.
Ellis, did you know the shirts that we got from Ojillies, they're glow-in-the-dark?
They are?
Yeah, the 4014 ones.
Swag!
Yeah, the black one, with the one with the semaphore is glow-in-the-dark.
That's pretty great.
Dark.
No.
Dark.
They have UP also has 5511, 838, all those other locomotives. I guess they just don't care about them anymore, sadly.
Yeah. Well, 838 really is a parts.
830. Oh well.
UP did care about heritage.
UP crushing my dreams every day, all day every day.
Crush dreams every day.
That's why we took over the main line. From Eugene the Portland. On the Oregon 7.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
That's the way things happen on the Oregon.
Oh, spring. Jesus Christ! Express!
Express!
Jesus.
Moments brought to you by me almost crashing into trees in War Thunder.
Yeah.
Can I go. Oh, never mind.
What?
I have news.
Yeah, I was about to ask. What's up with you?
If you're in Texas,
uh-oh,
and you want to go to a Polar Express ride, the Texas State Railroad has all of next week and the week after that free. If you want to go and take your kids out, have fun, ride the trains.
Let's be honest, the people listening to this podcast probably don't have kids.
But okay, then take
your parents out, guys.
Go take them for a walk.
What was that? The Onion article, in X amount of years, the Heritage Railroads are going to be completely overwhelmed by the number of retirees.
Yep. The best. I saw something in whoever it was. I saw that somebody on the narrow gauge forum actually cited that, and they didn't realize it was the Onion, and they started flipping out.
How so?
Like they're, oh my god, we need to.
Like, so excitedly, or what?
No, like, bad. Like, oh my god, this is a detriment, we're all gonna die!
Jesus Christ.
Oh my god.
Alcoholic bar.
Yeah. And then the first person in the comments pointed out, yeah, from America's finest news source. In our Gage forum. Should probably check that.
Yeah. Do your job while I'm old.
Make sure there's nothing new.
Yeah.
Anything else from you? Also, anything else from you, Kevon?
Also, over the break, I just had to write an essay.
A research paper.
And I did a research paper on why maglevs should replace high-speed rail. And recently, out of New York, the Federal Railroad Administration has had approved a $27.8 million project to see if maglevs will be viable from Washington to New York. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Swaglevs.
So, the Acela might be replaced with maglevs soon.
Well, I mean, the Acela is going to be replaced pretty soon anyways. They're getting towards the end of their lifespan here.
Yeah.
Sadly. Oh.
Yeah. I figure they
real
should
quick,
just...
478 to... Okay. What? Sorry. I thought you were done.
No, I was going to say, they should just transplant them to the West Coast and start making a thing out there.
Yeah.
The Northwest Corridor.
Or Texas. We need it.
They're already going to do that kind of...
Well, yeah, I know, but they should give you the Acelas. Secondhand. Jeez. Don't give me no handmade drown trains.
I mean, what are they going to do with the Acelas? Like, they can't... I guess scrap them?
Yeah.
Speed.
But they're
gonna,
oh my god.
The Railroad Museum of Pennsylvania is probably going to get one of them, and then they're going to scrap the rest.
Oh.
Wow.
Or they'll end up like the turbo trains. Just in a yard, waiting to be scrapped.
And forever.
Turbo train.
Yes.
Turbo train hype train.
No.
What else? The infinite turbo train.
Infinite turbo train.
The first
infinite turbo.
The first GIF I ever posted on Reddit. Anyways. Let me real quick. What?
Real quick.
All right.
Off of the Narrow Gauge forum, because that apparently I should check that as a news source. I don't know why I don't more. 478's alive.
Wait, what?
Yay. 478's alive.
You what, mate?
Congratulations.
I thought it was dead.
478, well, no, I can't remember what had happened to. She either shat a bearing or something with the mud ring or something. I don't know. Something went wrong with 478. And now it's back. So,
oh,
yeah.
That's good.
They're thinking it wasn't going to be coming back anytime soon, and that honestly was one of the reasons they were looking at trading it with Kimmers and Toltec.
Mm-hmm.
So, whoa. As soon as that fell through, they were like, okay, we might as well go ahead and fix this stupid
fix
thing.
This.
And they fixed it. Alright, we can't get rid of it, we might as well fix it, so they did.
And look, it's the gorge.
The gorge?
Why would you can't see it?
It's bad.
It's not bad.
Oh, it actually looks nice.
Yeah. Half of it is good. Well, half of it is getting there.
Nice. Good to you.
It's passable.
It's passable.
It's a lot better than that Durango and Silverton route.
Yes, it is.
Anyways, Scranton, Pennsylvania, the National Park Service turns 100 years old in 2016 and wants everyone to celebrate. All national parks, including Steamtown Historic Site, will waive entrance fees on 16 special days in 2016. I don't think this waiving of the fees is particularly special, but I'm going to go with them anyways. I'm pretty sure they do this kind of thing every year. Yeah, they definitely do. Anyways, January 18th, Martin Luther King Jr. Day. April 16th to the 24th, which is National Park Week. August 25th through 28th, which is the National Park Service birthday weekend. September 24th, I am going to Steamtown.
Woo!
Yay.
That is the day after my birthday. I'm going to Steamtown. National Public Lands Day, and November 11th, Veterans Day. So those are their 16 entrance fee free days in 2016. So, and the entrance fee to Steamtown is only $7 a person anyways, so...
That's not bad.
It's
that's
really reasonable.
Cheap.
And also, you know, that's really just to go inside. You can dick around in the yard for free.
Yeah.
I do that every time I go there. So anyways, whoever wants to come visit Steamtown with me?
I want to, but I don't know.
Hey, wait.
It's in September. It's if I have finals. Mm. If I don't, then maybe.
You have finals in September?
Well, midterms.
Oh. I think I'll be off at Wayward Engineering School.
Yeah, we have a dumpster to take.
Is it really a lucrative dumpster?
You know. 40 days of dumpster.
We have a dumpster to shove.
Wait, you're gonna be pushing around the dumpster on my birthday? Swag.
I don't know what day would be your birthday.
The 23rd.
Yep.
Yes.
Whip.
Hopefully, we'll have.
But yeah, we get to go dumpster shoving. Hopefully by that point next year, I won't be riding in the dumpster.
Yeah, maybe you'll have a little bit more clout.
Yeah.
Maybe you'll be driving the dumpster.
No.
Well, I was driving the dumpster this year.
Oh.
Driving in inverted commas.
And it sucks?
It doesn't suck. It's a little bit boring, in all honesty, because you drive and you do the trip, which is 20 minutes on the dot.
On the dot.
No less.
On the dot.
No less. It's exactly 20 minutes, TM. You do the trip, which is 20 minutes, and then you'll sit for about 40 minutes while everybody gets off of the train, and the other group gets on the train, and everybody takes a picture with Thomas. With the new eye mechanism, the way that it looks back and forth, they only take the picture when he looks at the camera.
Oh, no.
So they put photographers on either side of the track, and one of them will take a picture, and then Thomas will look at the other one, and they'll take a picture, and they're trying to really quickly set up the other one, so they'll look back at the other ones, and they'll take a picture, and they'll look back. If they miss them, it delays it by, like, 30 seconds each time they miss this 10-second margin.
Oh, my God.
And there's no way to turn it off. The old one, it was just a lever that you'd use to kind of waggle the eyes back and forth, and you could point it one direction and keep it in that direction. This one just does. So, yeah.
Does it talk?
It does.
Oh, God. I saw a video of that. The talking is so creepy.
The Strasbourg.
Hello. Really cool. My name is Thomas.
It's really cool, but it's really creepy. Cool.
I don't think it's creepy at all. I think it's actually really cool.
Thomas is coming to life. They're going to murder him.
Okay, look at... You say that one's creepy? Look at the one we had when we were kids. That's creepy.
Yeah.
The rape train has no brakes.
That is creepy.
The rape train has no brakes.
Yeah, the new face is not that bad, and the voice isn't...
Well, next thing, they're going to develop AI for Thomas, and then he's going to become sentient. What are you going to do then?
And then you're going to have a bad time.
Anyways, I've got one more big piece of news.
Yes.
The trade secret chemical formula and annealing process for General Casting's nickel, General Steel Casting's nickel steel, what you make box pock drivers out of, has been discovered. The T1 Trust was able to identify the chemical and material properties for General Steel Casting's nickel steel. And working with Beaver Valley Alloy and a national materials testing laboratory, the T1 Trust has used 21st century technology to successfully replicate this steel, bringing back this extinct class of steel. So now that they've gotten the money to make the centers, and now they know what the wheels are made out of. You know, it strikes me as... It's kind of mind-boggling, actually, the fact that, you know, they had no idea what they were made of.
Yeah.
This sort of process has been lost to history. Why? Because nobody needs them. Oh, look, you're going through Milky's section.
Rip physics.
Yeah.
Wow. Tell us how you really feel. Is Milky here anymore?
Yeah, I'm
he
here.
He left in shame.
Oh.
You people are just... You're just insulting him to his face then? Okay.
I like it. Hey.
Jeez.
I mean, it looks good.
Remember Replacement Ogilius.
It looks good. It's kind of all over the place. This is not the first time I have discussed this with him. Or discussed this around him, or, you know, even brought up the topic at all, that this section needs replacement. Because the turns are very, very sharp.
I see.
Yeah. I don't know. It doesn't... I'll talk about it later. If I'm going to talk about it, it belongs in a different section.
Yeah.
Yes.
Shame for Despray.
Shame for Despray.
So yeah, that is the last of the news, is it not?
Yeah, I believe it is.
All right,
that's
well,
it for me.
We're moving on to our discussion topic, which is also...
In a way, yeah.
In a way.
In a way.
Approximately a week and 2 days from now is the anniversary of the original Zombie Train. That is the third anniversary of the day the world ended, December 21st, 2012.
Well, actually, I thought it actually was going to.
The Great Panic. Of course you did.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And now we're all in purgatory during the podcast.
This is our eternal hell. Just to
I was going
to
say, you're calling it purgatory?
This is our hell.
Anyways.
105 hell.
A level one of robot hell. With the third anniversary of the Zombie Train rapidly approaching, a recent YouTube comment on the original video has gotten me thinking, can we build a better Zombie Train? Well,
yes.
Of course we can.
Yes.
But how? So we're going to talk about the pros and cons of different potential locomotives to be used in the kind of situation where my Zombie Train ends up falling, which is that of, instead of a simple survival mechanism, that of an errand boy. So it's going to be something that gets used all the time for a variety of different kinds of loads.
Yeah. It, at the same time, it still has to fulfill...
It has to fulfill all the basic aspects as well, you know. It needs to keep you moving, it needs to keep you powered, it needs to not burn through all of your fuel in one sitting, and also enable you to get out of Dodge when you really need to.
Yeah.
Yep.
It needs to be able to navigate situations that engines were perhaps not designed to navigate, such as excessive amounts of debris or damaged track.
Debris.
See.
So, Wybold, I know you're not taking a side in this.
Yep.
You're going to be our fact checker.
I've officially, unofficially, soon TM, resigned from Locomotive Versus.
After killing the EVT.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or you killed something else later that day. I don't remember what it was, though.
No.
Anyways.
Did I kill?
I don't remember just being like, first you killed the EBT, and now this.
And now
what if the EBT was not kill?
Da-na-na-na.
What if the EBT was still running?
That'd be nice.
That'd be nice.
Yeah. Save the EBT.
Save the EBT. Anyways.
Screw Wong.
I'm gonna take.
Whoa!
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
I know who's. I'm not taking sides with in this battle.
Jader, just as you got out of the woods,
you got way back into them.
I saw something shiny.
Jader, you're effed.
Yeah, you are.
So, Jader, what's your idea then?
I don't care, it's wrong.
So he's gonna kill whatever dude.
Bass.
I will be impartial. Maybe.
I'll be impartial except for Jader.
Uh-huh.
Gotcha. Wow.
Everyone, all people are equal, though some are more equal than others.
Jesus.
You trash. No.
I mean, I'm personally favorable for standing behind Blount as a whole. I mean, I'm not entirely sure what advantages he has over some of the other engines I've encountered or thought up. But, you know, I at least can have him on the style point that he was there and he was available. And I know he was running, at least, on December 21st, 2012.
Mm-hmm.
And wouldn't have needed any sort of preliminary maintenance other than, you know, just starting it up and going.
Which even you didn't do.
What?
Which even you didn't do.
Well, I did I remember greasing it and stuff. I did some basic stuff. I wrote in the story the cop out of, you know, they were.
It's already fired up.
Not that it was already fired up, but they were preparing for an excursion. They had everything all set up, and then they canceled it because of the Great Panic. But anyways, yeah. Mm. So at least I know he's running. I'm gonna bring up everybody's suggestions and show them on the main screen here as people bring them in now. Milky.
Okay, I'll be mine.
You had a terrible decision.
Yeah. Mine got the most frack out of all of them.
Well, you're the only one who's said anything thus far, anyways.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. But I chose Norfolk and Western number 1218.
Why you might hang on, so NW1218, okay. And we have CN. What's Bond's number again?
3254.
Oh, right, 3254. Okay.
Why did I choose 1218?
Because it's huge and the babes go wild, right? You're gonna get all the chicks and zombies. Yeah, I mean, you have to repopulate the earth somehow. I get it.
Jeez.
But I think you're compensating.
A little.
Okay.
I'll let you blow out.
Jesus Christ.
I chose it because 1218 can haul any lane that you need to haul.
Mm-hmm.
And it can go fast while doing it.
Mm-hmm.
But
I'll believe that it can go fast. It has... It's modern enough, it has a high enough boiler pressure, it's got decent-sized drive wheels, it's not a compound Malay, so...
That's true.
I'll give him the fast. If he wants to have fast as part of his, you know,
time
a component
to
of...
fast!
Yeah.
Yes, if he wants to have fast, he can have fast. Give me a second.
Alright, I'm gonna bring up everyone's in steam locomotive as well.
But here's the thing.
Yeah?
With 1218, or, you know, with a... You know, if the world is ending, wouldn't you want something light?
You don't want to break the tracks, it's true.
That's true, but you don't want to break down in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, but you...
Well, you have more moving parts, you're probably going to break down. Not saying you couldn't, you know, push through that. Because you've got an extra set of drive wheels, but even still.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm back.
We're talking about how heavy things are, and also maintenance.
And end up being changed to be.
Well, we'll get into that eventually.
Jader, do you have anything? Because I think I know something that you could do.
I was gonna go out on a limb here and say a nickel plate Burke.
Mm-hmm. 765 was actually one of the ones that I, was. You know, I actually write in one of the stories that I'm jealous of the fact that I don't have it, because we end up giving it to somebody else.
Hmm.
And it's definitely got, you know, compared to Blount, it's got more power, it's got more speed. It's a heavier and larger engine, but it will do, you know, much like 1218, it'll do anything demanded of it.
Yeah, unless it's the one in trains.
Thanks, K&L.
And you're slipping every time you just try to move.
Oh. I can't wait for the 1218 when they come up.
And as long as it doesn't slip like the Burke, I'll buy it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'll buy it. I can't wait for the Q2.
Q2 hype.
Let me bring this guy up. New York, Chicago, and St. Louis. The S-Class.
Mm-hmm.
You had quite
Mercedes
a few.
S-Class.
These are earlier than I thought they were, actually. Although, they're still... Well, they're only 2 years older than... they're only 2 years older than 1218. Blount, on the other hand, is old.
Yeah. 1218 is pretty new compared to... most...
And it shows, they're modern locomotives.
Yeah, NNW made good modern locomotives, by all means.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we all know what 765 looks like at this point, but I'm bringing up a picture of her anyways.
Right, 611 was like number 2 on my list.
611 was number 2 on your list. Well, I mean, frankly, I think it would have been more reasonable.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and considering it's running right now.
Although, keep in mind, neither of these were running back then.
Running back then.
Yeah.
What was that?
Yeah.
Who's echoing?
Not me.
I don't think it's me.
Not me.
I don't know. Why, whatever. Anyways. Okay. Let's see. Let me look at something real quick here. So, you have 765 as the largest drivers out of all. Oh, no. Whoa. No, it doesn't.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't.
What?
It doesn't?
Mm-mm.
What? What, mate?
It's got 69-inch drivers, and 1218 actually has 70-inch drivers.
Oh.
What?
Those guys, M&W.
And a higher boiler pressure as well.
But that's because of articulated.
Mm.
And it's a bigger boiler.
Yeah.
And it is the only one that cracks 100,000 in terms of... I need to get to the Canadian stuff.
Oh yeah, it's cute. It's a pretty good water capacity.
Mm.
Yeah, well, before we bring Kevon, or statistics and specifics into this, shouldn't we bring Kevon in?
Yeah, Kevon.
What's his engine?
I was thinking...
Oh no.
I have a okay idea, but there's the K-37s. While they are narrow gauge, they were converted.
I know. What are you going to do? Convert it back?
You're not getting style points for that. Just so you know. I know that
you can run it on both narrow gauge and standard gauge. That
no,
was
no,
you
can't. No,
you
but
can not both. No. Narrow gauge.
You can't run both. But
it
you,
needs an
yeah.
overhaul to like go from one to the other.
I know. Okay. Besides that, I was going to say
an overhaul. It needs a new frame.
Yeah, I know.
Jesus Christ.
I just had ideas in my head, but I was going to go with Southern 4501.
Okay, there we go.
Okay. Good boy.
That was my second.
I'm going to chip in here and say that, Wybold, you had an idea, even though you weren't taking sides in this one. You had an idea which I did like.
That was not a serious idea, really. It was sort of just kind of spitballing good qualities.
Yeah, it's not bad necessarily. Yeah.
It was more so an example of something that would be good, you know, based upon the qualities it had.
Yeah. Mm. So was anything here. Mm. You know.
Yeah.
Except for what I said.
And
goddamn it, come on.
We did open it up a little bit. You know, 1218 obviously wasn't in running condition at this point. Was 765 in running condition in 2012?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. 3254 was 4501?
4501 was being restored.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. So that could pose a problem. How far along were they?
Let me check again.
Granted, with 1218...
They might have had the tender decking done, but I don't know.
They might have had the tender decking. Okay, well, we don't know.
I don't know.
You know.
Well, with M&W, you could switch out parts with pretty much any engine, so there was a source of parts right next to 1218.
What do you base that on?
Yeah, I don't know where you're getting that.
It wasn't M&W. Operatable until 2014, so.
Oh.
They were not very far along.
Yeah. Because either if you catch it right at the beginning or right at the end, you kind of are all set. Because, you know, right at the beginning, they go into overhauls not because the engines are about to blow up. Just because they have to.
It's legal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Granted, 1218 was like halfway through a rebuild when they put it on display, so.
Mm. Well,
that could have an impact on it, possibly.
Yeah, you might want to figure out what kind of condition.
Wait, didn't they just tack it together, like, just so it would look good?
Pretty much, but I think the parts are still there.
It looks like it has most of its fittings. Let me look at it.
Oh, great.
Really?
I heard the... Wait, no, that's a different thing.
It may be missing internals, but as far as fittings are concerned, it still has its safeties. It still has... it still has stuff like that. Mm-hmm. It might just be, you know, it looks that good on display, but it looks mostly complete.
Okay.
It's still got all of its rods. Okay. It's still got most of the piping.
It still is in one piece for the most part.
Yeah, that's important.
It's not missing a lot. by just immediate looks. It's not missing a heck of a lot.
I just realized how old 4501 is. That puts it at a pretty severe disadvantage in terms of stuff. It's got a boiler pressure of 180. Blount also has the same boiler pressure as well, actually. And 4501 has significantly larger drive wheels.
Yeah, well, here's the thing that makes this discussion specifically interesting. Is a higher boiler pressure necessarily a good thing?
It enables you to get more power out of your engine.
It enables you to get more power out of your engine, but to generate that pressure takes a lot longer to bring the engine into steam. It takes more fuel to do so. It takes more water. It's usually a lot larger boiler. Cough, cough, 1218. Higher pressure, in normal freight service is something you want, but in this sort of scenario where resources are limited, yes, it's still a good thing in some ways, but there is a significant list of cons to it as well.
Does having a higher maximum boiler pressure then indicate that you need to get to a higher pressure before anything's workable?
In some respects. To move the engine itself, not necessarily. To run the compressor, it depends on how it's calibrated. Something like, basically the biggest calculation, well, the biggest thing to take into account with boiler pressure is the brakes. In order to move a train, you have to have more boiler pressure than you need pressure to release the brakes, because you can't use, because the air compressor runs on steam and you can't make 50 PSI with 30 PSI.
Yeah.
So if you need 90 PSI to release the brakes, you want to have your reservoir at about 170. This is just on 91, by the way. Release the brakes at 90. Main reservoir is about 150. Boiler pressure has to be above 150, or else your brakes start to come on.
Oh.
There is no way to release. If your boiler pressure drops below your main reservoir, you lose air pressure, and the brakes start applying.
Oh, okay.
When firemen don't fire the engine well enough and it runs out of steam, the engine doesn't come to a stop because it doesn't have enough steam to move the pistons. It stops because it runs out of enough steam to run the brakes, and the entire train goes into emergency. That's the issue with the boiler pressure. And again, it depends on calibration, and I'm not terribly familiar with, you know, something like standard gauge and if there's a difference there, or more modern equipment and stuff like that, but from my understanding, again, a higher boiler pressure may not be good just on the basis of time. You are going to be sitting there longer waiting for it to build boiler pressure, even if it is superheated. You're going to be sitting there waiting for it longer to release the brakes. Which, you know, specifically in the context of ZT, is not something you want.
You don't want to be sitting around.
And that's the kind of thing. 1218, I'm going to pick on 1218 here a little bit because it does have the highest boiler pressure, and it stands as the best example of this. Yes, it might be able to go very quickly, but it cannot start very quickly. You're going to have to fuss around it for a very long time before it even gets an inclination to start going. That's why locomotives' independent brakes are inverse to the train brakes. More pressure equals stop on the locomotive. It's that you can move it around the yard without it having air charged up. You don't have to charge the air reservoir or bring it into steam just to shove the engine around in and out of the shop or something.
Was that part of why, I recall in Beta Rail you wrote in that you inverted the brakes?
That was very much a cop-out.
Yeah, just so you could crash the train.
Well, not necessarily. It wasn't so that we could crash it. It was so that inverting the brakes in this sort of scenario, yes, it would be very good because you'd be able to move the thing without.
Yeah.
You know, it does have obvious implications. You know, maybe
dangerous implications.
Right. It has the issue that there's no guarantee you're able to stop the train. But at the same time, you're able to get up and move very quickly. You're not stuck anywhere waiting for the train to charge up the brakes, because remember, every single car that you couple on has its own air reservoir, and you have to wait for every car that you connect, you cut them in one by one by one, and you wait for the pressure to equalize with that car and the locomotive, and then you wait for the locomotive to build the pressure up in both of them a little bit more with the compressor, and then you cut in another car and do it again and again and again and again until finally the entire train is equal pressure with the air reservoir of the engine. Again, all the while, you have to be keeping the steam pressure up and the main reservoir up, otherwise brakes don't release and you don't have the capability to do so. You have to run the compressor, you have to keep air in the lines. You know, granted, I say that the inverting the brakes thing was a cop-out because there really isn't a way to do it with Westinghouse brakes very easily, and it's something that, even if you could do it, which, yeah, there's a way, but it does take a lot of time to do that, and that's something that I didn't touch on in the story, and it's one of the reasons that I consider that, you know, a cop-out.
Up for a rewrite.
Yeah, it's up for a rewrite, and it needs to be reassessed because, again, that was really just a means of, like, you know, we'll make this a little bit easier on ourselves, and we don't have to deal with waiting around forever.
By the way, here are the steam locomotive pages for all of the engines.
Okay.
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 I am noticing that because of... Mine is a slightly newer engine than... I'm mainly looking at the primary competition to me here, which is... 4501.
Yeah.
4501 has a lower coal capacity. I can understand why, because it doesn't have a giant bucket on the tender. And although the tender is higher in general, like it's a more beefy tender. It's longer.
Yeah.
So I think
also it has a not a Vanderbilt, an auxiliary.
Does it?
It does.
Well, that's just for water, but yeah.
Oh, it has it now, yeah.
Yeah.
The picture I'm looking at, he doesn't have the auxiliary.
Yeah,
Is it green?
Depends. In pictures where the engine is painted black, it's black, and in where the engine is green, it is green.
Anyways.
It does, however, have an auxiliary tender, so bear that in mind as far as water capacity with that
engine.
Yeah,
it does have...
And it has had it for a long time. It had it in 2012.
Yeah, it does actually have a little bit more water capacity, just because the tender is overall larger.
Mm-hmm.
I have a new Gmont project.
It has a... it's a little bit heavier in terms of the minimum weight of rail. It needs 90, and Blount needs 85. And 85 is the... 85 and 90 are the outliers here. In terms of load, you know, they're very close together. And then 765
and 1218 are both a lot heavier.
765 is 105.
1218, oh my god.
1218 is 120.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
1218, honestly, is just not... If you want me to... I'm just going to come out and say it. 1218, if it hasn't been made apparent already, by my opinion, is not practical in this scenario.
It's too big. It's too big for your own good.
It is too big. Yes, it's good for a coal-hauling railroad in the 1950s where it has a constant supply of water, coal, and they're moving a heavy load at moderate speed. When you're trying to move a medium-sized to even lightweight load at high speeds very quickly between place to place, kind of, you know, scrambling and scavenging for materials, it's not practical. It burns way too much fuel. It burns way too much water. It's got way too high of a boiler pressure for it. It takes... a lot of grease. I look at all the bearings and the pin joints on that engine. Servicing it to get it ready just with grease and oil would take several hours. It would take a long time to get that engine moving. And even then, does it really do... You know, yeah, it can do more than the others, but you don't need it to do more.
I have an idea.
I just realized something about all of our other candidates here.
That being...
I don't know why it's just the Canadians that have done this, but none of the other candidates have all-weather cabs.
Yep. No, it doesn't.
Well, okay, some American stuff has done that, but...
Some American stuff has all-weather cabs, like 5629 does, but none of these ones do.
And, you know, obviously a cab forward has an all-weather cab. But we're not taking a cab forward.
But that's impossible. You need to bust in a museum and build
it belongs in a museum.
I would like to interject here that I'll shut up after this and let you guys go back to kind of deliberating amongst yourselves, because I've done a lot of talking, particularly around 1218.
Never good at that, but
I'd like to throw out with the all-weather cab, it's not necessarily such a good thing. I wouldn't necessarily consider it a bad thing, but at the same time, I wouldn't really consider it a good thing either.
Oh, because it's a hot box.
Right, in the cab of the engine. Oh, we were last night's a great example. We were with 491, which is a smaller engine than all of these, and the cab was a decent temperature. We're running in the snow at sub-zero temperatures at night, and the cab is warm.
The cab is nice.
You know, getting, if you get out of the engine to go and grease the bearings and stuff, you're cold and you can't feel your fingers within 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're back in the cab, it's warm enough. A fire is a fire is a fire is a fire, and the cab is warm enough despite whether it's all weather or not. In the summer, however, 91's cab got hot. And 91 has a pretty open cab, even compared to some of the other non-all-weather cabs in this.
Mm-hmm.
So bear that in mind. Even though it is, you know, feasibly better for winter and you could, you have more play over the warmth of the cab in the winter, in the summer, it's more of a curse. You're going to be exhausted and sweating very quickly.
It isn't necessarily about winter, though. It's about zombies.
Yeah.
Okay. That's a valid point.
You know, it's, you know, and obviously the all-weather cab is, you know, like you said, it can be an easier way to control the temperature, whatever. It's an easier way to control people busting into your engine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or, you know,
I'll give you that.
Formerly dead people.
That's fair.
I don't know. It, you know, and it is just kind of a thing where I'll admit it's something that I came up with as you were talking. You know, it occurred to me there.
Uh-huh.
But it's the kind of thing where that's the practicality sake of it.
Yeah, it is a valid point, actually. I hadn't considered that. That's a very valid point.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that is a very big advantage of the all-weather cab, whereas, you know, the other stuff where, as far as being a locomotive goes, an all-weather cab really isn't all that great.
Mm-hmm.
They were done really... That's why they're super uncommon. They were done mainly just to streamline engines, and even at that, not very often.
Yeah, but this is Canada.
Yeah, this is Canada. They were done to more modern stuff, but there are a myriad of reasons for that. The engines got a little bit less... You know, you're not shoveling coal, so you're not constantly letting heat into the cab from the firebox, and it's a little bit more controlled that way, especially on larger engines. But that's as far as a locomotive goes, the all-weather cab isn't that great. As far as this specifically goes, that's a very valid point.
Yeah.
So, what kind of scenarios, Milky included here, what kind of scenarios do you guys think would show the strengths of your engines?
Okay. Like, if you need to move a whole bunch of stuff from, like, your setup to a new setup.
Yeah, if you're moving a whole settlement in type, you'd want something oversized, basically.
So it'd be basically a circus train.
Yeah, basically.
Yes. Yes. So if you want to haul your entire circus...
My next trick, I will run this engine despite not having fuel for it.
No, well... Oh.
That's why you have hoppers and tank cars full of water for it.
I mean, hell, in the zombie train, though, we actually restarted a coal mine. We gathered up people and said, okay, well, here's an old mine. We're going to try and... old in inverted commas, because it's just like, here's an abandoned mine, just like everything else is abandoned. We're going to try and get some fuel out of it, because running all over the place, even for Blount, is not the easiest setup.
Yeah. Like, I can imagine behind Job 18 having, like, 5 cold callers full.
Unfortunately, moving stuff from the cold cars into the tender isn't always straightforward.
No.
Yeah,
unfortunately. Yeah, you need a crane or something.
Unfortunately, Job 18 isn't one of those fancier tickets with the auto stoker.
It does stoker?
It doesn't have a stoker.
Or apparently it was... I'm not quite sure.
You'd kill yourself shoveling that thing.
You would.
Yeah.
You could have 5 people shoveling that and you'd kill it. Or you'd kill yourself. That firebox is almost twice the size of 91's. And if you're working it in the conditions you're talking about with hauling a lot of people very quickly...
No, it's got to have an auto stoker. It's got to have an auto stoker. Come on.
Yeah, that's not practical. There's no way the N&W built it without an auto stoker.
Max consumption rates per hour were 7 tons of coal burned and 116,000 pounds of water evaporated. Why pounds? of water evaporated.
That's not how that works.
That's unhelpful. How many pounds of water is in the tender? You didn't give me the capacity in pounds of water.
Also, to be fair, for 1218, just to give it a little bit of an advantage, it does have the oxy.
Yeah, but someone up in Ohio...
What are you going, I'm trying to help you for once.
Yeah, I know, but the people up in Ohio that own 765 own that tender.
Wrong state.
Okay, then the advantage go to Jader.
You just
screw you too.
It was working out for Milton.
The last time I helped you.
It worked out for me.
But who said that I wasn't going to take it?
You're the one who gave it away. You surrendered it. So no, you can't have it.
Jesus.
F you too.
Okay.
You can't have it. You don't want it, you can't have it. It's Jader's now. So Jader has an auxiliary tender as well as a very large tender to begin with.
Yeah, Jader, you definitely excel. You know, the A-class could, you know, theoretically, apparently, haul a passenger train at 70 miles an hour.
And it can haul 100-car coal trains.
Yes.
Don't pop up a grade.
Jader, how fast have they gotten 765 in excursion service, do you know?
Probably not as fast.
Probably not max speed, but...
like
It's the same thing with Tornado.
Maybe,
it's not even a matter of their stupid, it's speed limits. They're not allowed to go that fast.
Maybe 50?
Mm. I mean, there's a picture where I'm looking at. The one I have right now is her on a horseshoe curve, actually. And I know, I'm fairly certain the speed limit through there would be...
70.
So, you know, at least on that line would be 79.
Let's put it this way. She can go fast.
Hmm.
491 has freakishly oversized mountain climbing, you know, giant stroke pistons and little itty-bitty wheels, and she can do 50. So, she can do 50-60 on a good day. So this engine can go quickly.
Yeah.
It can do 80 at least.
Time to fast.
Frankly, I do want to know... what the fastest they've gotten these Berkshires up to is.
I think I've heard, like...
I think they can go 80. So...
I've heard, like, 90.
I don't know.
They managed to do it.
Do we want to just kind of pick a number that sounds reasonable?
Yeah. I mean, definitely... Definitely at least, you know, at least the A-class and probably beating it by even 10 miles an hour or 20 miles an hour.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Wait, I forgot something. I'm supposed to be screwing Jader, aren't I?
Nah, whatever.
You in turn helped him.
You're screwing Milky now.
Yeah.
Well, Milky...
Stop screwing me.
Yes. Milky screwed himself.
Get happy for the...
Yeah,
you screwed yourself with that choice. You brought it to us a couple days ago, and we presented reasons like, no, it's really not a good idea. You brought this upon yourself. Jader, I'd like to point out, what the heck is wrong with your running boards? You can't get out the front of the cab.
wait, what? Oh, yeah.
You know how usually there's a door on the front of the cab and you can get out on the running boards?
Yeah.
The running board on 765 cuts it in half. There's just a window.
It's like a head level.
Yeah.
Although, it's no better on 1218.
Okay, well, then 1218 too. F2. 3254 is good. She has a door. 4501 has a door, like normal engines.
You can walk up to the number boards.
Try that at 60.
Polar
You'd
Express.
Have to walk pretty quickly.
Challenge accepted, bitch.
You're gonna run at 60 miles an hour. And
although,
jump
wait, is there like a foothold on the side of the cab so you can just step out of the cab, shimmy along the cab, and then step up onto the?
Not on 765 and not on 1218.
Okay.
I don't know, but this is a nice picture.
You could do some serious parkour and do that, but
You could feasibly open the window. You could take a yardstick, prod the window so that it's open, and do a flying dive over the Johnson bar and slide onto the running board. You could try that.
You could try that. And then you'd fall off and die.
And then you fall off and die.
That's interesting. You know, I haven't seen... Okay, you know what? I'm going to look something up now.
To help 1218, though... Milky, don't... Just shush, okay. I'm giving you something here. To be fair to 1218, though, it does have a lot of grab irons, which are very helpful, especially on a large engine like this. Grab irons is something that they're difficult because they're not. They're kind of a pain. They're surprisingly. It's surprising how big of a pain in the ass they are to put on.
Mm-hmm.
Like you'd think they're the easiest thing to install in the engine. They're actually really a pain, but they're and so then, nice.
It looks like It looks like a lot of more modern engines. You don't actually get the door.
Yeah.
I wonder why.
I don't know. They don't feel the need for somebody to walk out into the front of the engine while it's running.
It's probably too dangerous. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I understand that it's too dangerous, but
if
still,
it's there, people will use it.
I'm still, even though it is a modern engines thing, I'm still going to use it as a negative.
Oh,
against
I don't blame you. I just went to look
for
it up.
For this scenario, it's impractical. Why would you do that?
Okay.
Why would you subject yourself to that? And see, I like, you know, I'm almost rooting for 765 here, partly because I don't want to see us go, you know, it was good enough, and partly because, you know, I really like the idea of more power, and you know this isn't at least in my thinking an excessive amount of more power.
Hmm.
What for 765?
Yeah.
No, probably not.
Yeah, it's
considering all the others. No, not really.
Mm-hmm.
It's I mean it's sort of the next logical step up,
okay.
But again it's a lot more difficult to. It's a modern engine's got a higher boiler pressure. It has all the detractors of a modern engine.
Hey, 4501.
Yeah, I know. It's older, but it's still heavier. You know, it's getting too old at that point. Blount actually has the best factor of adhesion of anybody here.
Yeah,
hold on, which one is that one? S1 Basic is 3.97. So it's 0.03 from the perfect 4.
Ah, I'm so sad.
Yeah, you're 0.06.
Mm-hmm.
From the perfect 4.
Disappointment. No, but its boiler did get upgraded to 205 PSI.
You know, I'm not entirely sure to see what the advantage disadvantage of that is. The retractive effort of the S1 Basic of 51,638 pounds, and then the tractive effort of Stallion over here, of 53,113 pounds. So it's a very, very close race in terms of power. You've got a little bit more.
Devon, that's made out of something on 1218.
Oh wait, no, S1 Basic. I was looking at the one at the beginning. You've actually got the same size drive wheels as I do. They've got 63-inch drivers, and, you know, 765 has 69, and the A-Class has 70.
Okay, back. Sorry.
Wait, 70?
70.
Okay.
The A-Class has 70-inch drivers.
Oh, wow, the A-Class has...
Blount and Stallion both have 63-inch drivers, and Andy has 69-inch drivers. 245 boiler pressure.
I have no
what?
Design point to go for.
What?
1218's Tendu has a doghouse.
It's true, you could have somebody looking out the back of the, you know, watching your back.
Okay. Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah. Somebody back there with a sniper rifle?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
That'd actually be awesome.
It would be, and that's why...
That's a fair point.
Yeah.
It's used in this kind of scenario.
Additionally, Jader's Vanderbilt or Jader's auxiliary tender, because it's not Milky's anymore, has a little storage section on it.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Door.
The garage door at the back.
The garage door tender. Oh no.
What's that even for?
But you know, 6A Eben has one too. That's also at the museum. Who said that it couldn't be used for 1218?
You brought this on yourself.
Yeah, you.
Yep.
You gave away
can't
it,
have
right.
The Vanderbilt. You can't have a Vandy, or not a Vandy. Why do I keep wanting to say Vandy?
Because they're awful.
You can't. They're awesome. You can't have an Oxy. You've lost your Oxy privileges. Okay.
But I just named it.
No, I'm taking away the Oxy.
AUX tender.
AU extender.
It's not my fault NNW made more than one auxiliary tender.
Oh, but you can't have it.
Well, I think we can...
I tried to help you, and you turned your nose up at it.
I think we can definitely decide that having a Malay is pretty much too large for all of the purposes here.
It's way too consuming of everything. Fuel, water, fuel, water, grease, oil, everything. Yeah. It's not practical at all.
Hey, I could have said the big boy, and I could have said Fus.
The problem,
and they're both equal, and they're both equally impractical.
The problem with 765, it's a very modern engine. It's a very complicated engine, as well.
It is.
It's
got stuff that's easy to break. It's got power reverse. It's got. Does it have Baker valve gear?
I'm looking. Yep, it's got Baker.
What?
Baker valve gear, oddly
Wait,
enough.
isn't that better?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so yeah. It's got Baker. It's got that good. Going for it.
Especially in this, because maintenance isn't one of those things. It's one of those things you want it to be easy, but the pin makes it easier to do.
Mm-hmm.
You're less likely to know how to do it, but the pin makes it easier to repair, so that's better.
In our situation, knowing how to do it wasn't necessarily what we... Our strong suit, and we come into it and be like, I think this is how we run an engine.
I think this is kind of broken. 765 also has a really big sand dome and a lot of sand capacity, which is
huge
last night.
Sand dome.
In light of last night's events at the museum, I'm going to advocate and say that sand is important.
Yeah, sand is good. Me. Sand is definitely good. Also, look at that effing firebox. On the picture of. On Jader's picture, that's an enormous firebox.
That is a very big firebox.
Super power.
Yeah, power at speed.
Yes.
And you've really got a lot going for it. Does 765 have a booster?
No.
Okay, well, I don't know. I think it's kind of a shame. I like the idea. I like boosters.
I mean,
although it's something else to break, so.
Yeah.
You never have to use it. But it's the kind of thing that'll take you all over. What is... None of these are all still coal-fired, so that's fine.
Yes, Kevon, run 302.
The idea that you can throw anything in the firebox and burn it, and you will go.
Yeah.
Is this kind of what we really hope for? What we need?
Even shoes.
Shoes, exactly.
And tires, thank you, Colorado. Yes.
We can throw... Wait, no. Who would we throw into the firebox? Or who would I...
Effing Dan.
Yes.
Yeah, throw TJ in the fire.
No. No, I meant the actual one.
Oh.
Anyways.
You mean the fake one, because the actual one would be TJ.
Well, no.
What?
Okay, anyways.
Can I go for something here?
Yeah, sure.
Toby Teen also has Baku Valve Q.
Yeah, but it's got two pairs of it, so, nah.
Yeah, you've got more stuff to break.
Well, STFU, I think.
Has anybody got more stuff in the front? Like, a lot of...
Job 18 has some
all
of, pretty
Well,
good.
What I mean is all, you know, a lot of engines, and you know how I don't like it, Weibold, when they have, like, the compressors up front or whatever.
Oh, no.
None of these engines have anything significant right above the cowcatcher or on the front of the boiler.
Yeah.
Although, except for maybe 765, I can't tell. Yeah, it looks like she's got some machinery in the front there.
Oh,
really? You're judging it off of looks on that?
Well, I'm looking at the picture. I'm just saying, you know, if it's a very high likelihood that you're going to be hitting stuff.
Yeah.
And if you've got something at the front of the engine that's going to get damaged all the time, you're gonna have a bad time. Like if you're driving around the boobs, you're probably going to puncture those things a lot.
That's because they're fake.
Those.
It's because they're fake.
Wow. And we're back to California. Hey-o!
Oh, my goodness. I'm checking the cylinders on these guys. You know, I'd really like to have the Berkshire, but I'm not sure how much more of an advantage it nets you over the Mikados.
Okay, so apparently with Trub 18... You can put the front coupler behind the plow, so...
Oh, well, that's nice.
Got a fold-out coupler, that's good.
That's a nice thing. As long as you don't snap it off.
I'll send you the picture that I'm referencing for this.
I caught the drift there. The biggest thing is as long as it doesn't get stuck that way.
Yeah, exactly. You have to bang the coupler back
in. If you have it closed and you hit something and it gets bent,
then you're in trouble.
It's stuck, and then you're hosed because you don't have a front coupler.
Yeah.
But it's better than the front coupler you hit and it just straight on.
Yeah, fair enough.
It at least protects the coupler. You know you have a workable coupler in there. You know, it's the only engine so far that can protect the coupler. I don't know.
Oh, it's...
as much as I say it, now that we've gone through all these things, I'm not sure there's as much of an advantage in switching to the Burke as I thought there was going to be.
Well, it does have advantages and it does have disadvantages.
Every engine does.
It is a little bit more powerful. Yeah, but yours doesn't have advantages.
Oh,
it's a little bit more powerful.
I will 1v1 you, mate.
Let's go.
Oh, you want to go?
War Thunder duels, let's go.
Oh, I was thinking next week, Locomotive versus
War Thunder
I'll
podcast?
Go.
After the podcast.
I was thinking Locomotive versus next week. Okay, well, I'll do that.
That's RIP Milky.
Messages.
Locomotive versus 75 versus 1218.
This shouldn't be great.
No.
Okay, I'll bring 4014 into this.
Anyway. God. What were you saying? You know.
They'll have advantages and disadvantages. Honestly, I think I would go with out of 3254 or 765, I think I would go with 765 for a few reasons.
And those are?
One, the tender has higher capacity.
Yeah.
In a place, and I'm going to talk about Colorado here because we don't have the coal shortage that you guys encounter every now and again.
Well, I mean,
you
a lot of things burned out here, you know, Great Panic is Great Panic, and, like, it would have been lovely if we were able to get, like, to the coal docks in Baltimore and have, you know, basically swim in coal for the rest of our days, except it all burned.
Yeah, well, I think more ability to carry more coal, because coal is something that, yeah, there's shortages of it here and there, but that's all the more reason you want to carry more of it. 765 has a very large tender, and even though 3254 has the bucket,
it does not compensate.
A higher capacity on 765. Additionally, 765 has roller bearings on the tender.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
New engine. No hot boxes.
And even though for whatever reason it has friction journals on the trailing truck, the pilot truck is also a roller bearing, whereas on 3254, it's an exposed hub.
Yeah.
Which, that's a lot of grease, and that's that's kind of a tricky thing to grease, actually, because you have to, like, reach around behind it and get on the hub.
Mm-hmm.
The sand capacity is also good. The water capacity is football's on. The water capacity is really good because it has the auxiliary. I almost said Vanderbilt again. Don't know why.
Mm-hmm.
It has the auxiliary. It's got that. The boiler pressure is higher, which it can be a disadvantage. It can also be an advantage, and at this size, not necessarily because the boiler isn't all that much bigger.
Yeah, you're going to be able to steam it up more or less quickly, and you've got a pretty big firebox to do it.
Yeah, the biggest one is you don't want a bigger boiler that is higher pressure because it takes more time to begin with, and then you're going to add another equation of let's take more time.
Yeah.
It's like doubling your time as opposed to quadrupling it. So even though the boiler pressure isn't a great thing on 765, it is high, and there's definitely worse things that you could do.
And also, because 765 has such a speed advantage over Blount, like, I don't figure Blount could get up past 60 or 65, you know? I mean, you could probably push it and, you know, eke 70 out of it, but I really don't think it would be able to manage that. It's not what it was supposed to do. Whereas 765 was like, you know, going the distance. Going for speed.
Going for speed.
It's also got... 765 also has more electrical fittings than 3254, even though 3254 is, you know, electric headlights and everything. It's better. Bellwether Cab on 3254 is better for this scenario, but out of preference, I'd stick with the open cab.
Mm-hmm.
Because one thing you don't really think about is look at 3254. Yeah, it's, you know, difficult. Picture yourself standing next to it, and then picture yourself standing next to 765.
Mm-hmm.
That's a long way up.
Yeah.
To get to that cab. So, yeah. Also, 765 has the same sort of... She has the same sort of injector that 91 does, which does really well with hot water, which is a trouble that you run into.
Oh, yeah?
Whereas 3254 has a more traditional injector, which does not like hot water, and when you have a tender that sits in the sun and is in, you know, proximity to a boiler and a firebox, water in the tender starts to heat up.
Yeah.
You know, it obviously doesn't boil, but you can start to get lukewarm water in the tender, and the old-style injectors don't really like lukewarm water, which can obviously be troublesome, because then you can't get water in the boiler, and you go boom.
Yeah, that could be bad.
765 has the power reverse. That's just an interesting...
It's something else to break, unfortunately, but it's helpful.
It's something else to break, which, yeah, it's not an advantage, especially on the factor that it's something you could break, and it's not easy to fix, nor is it something that you can
live without.
Replace.
It's not
something that you can, you know, either find another way of doing it or just ignore it. You need to have that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think, honestly, best candidates would be 765. I think, honestly, 3254 and 4501 are pretty close to tied.
They are very close. The only reason I'm rating 4501 a bit lower is because it's got a little bit higher ground pressures and, you know, needs a little bit of a heavier weight of rail. It's older, but it still has... it's older, but it still has about the same pressure, although it's got a worse factor of adhesion. And it's got the open cab as well. I don't know.
Yeah, and it's got some advantages as
well.
Where
do those guys?
It does have a little bit more power.
It's got a bigger plow. It's got a little bit more power. It's got the auxiliary tender. Its electronics are laid out a little bit better because Pile National Woo. You know, they're both, I'd consider them pretty close.
Yeah.
You know, I understand if you want to pick one out of the two, but understand that they are very, very close.
They are exceptionally close. You know, I feel like a lot of Mikados, especially from around this time period,
they do well. Mikados are good engines. They're good at mountain climbing. They're decent at mountain climbing. They're decent at high speeds. They don't take a heck of a lot of coal. You know, everybody kind of looks at, you know, Pacifics as being a sort of middle of the road engine. Honestly, I think Mikados are a better fit for that. You know, when you consider stuff like Malays and the really, really big stuff, I think Mikados are more of a middle of the road.
Yeah.
They're good engines, and I think they're both the same. And 1218
is extra.
I know that you're a bit salty about 1218. Because
salty, I don't think is the right word for it.
Yeah,
we feel bad for you because you're going to die.
No, I'm not.
R.I.P.
Hey, I'm going to die. There's no...
I don't think it's a good choice.
Go ahead.
Oh, no, go ahead. That's basically it. I don't think it's a good choice for this at all. It's got a couple of advantages over the others. Let's rephrase that. It's got a couple of advantages in general, but at the same time, it's only got one or two advantages over the others.
Yeah.
And then the disadvantages vastly outweigh it.
The fact of the matter is, it's too big.
Argue it,
Milky. If I can get away with running around in a Mikado for that many years, you know, as much as 765 would have helped me, this probably would have killed me.
Yeah. Milky, if you're so sure of it, then argue it. There is no arguing that it uses a lot more grease, or a lot more water, or a lot more coal. There is no arguing that it's a lot more mechanically complex, having two sets of valve gear and a giant pivot point. There's no arguing in that it's not nearly as efficient. It takes a lot heavier rail, and even though you can move things pretty quickly,
and you can move them by the bolt.
One of the things you have to keep in mind, and that I've encountered multiple times in the books, and Rybold, I have no doubt you've encountered as well, is that sometimes, your main route isn't going to be there anymore. And you've got to find the back way.
And 1218, that's something that you cannot do.
You will destroy the back way.
Yeah, you can.
No.
No.
Argue with that. You can. You're saying the reason that we're not necessarily upset with you, but the reason that we're starting to get a little bit irritated is because you're not presenting valid points. You're just sitting there and saying, no. Okay, then argue it. If you're so sure of that, then prove it.
Okay, when 1218 was doing her test runs back in 1987, they ran a 100-car coal train of a pretty good grade.
Well, yeah, but that has nothing to do with any of the things we just said.
No.
Hauling your whole circus from place to place.
Well, yeah. You can move heavy things, congratulations.
But you may not be able to move them if you're running out of water or running out of coal, or the tracks that you normally run on the 120-pound rail that you need is gone and you've got to settle for the 100-pound rail, which you're going to destroy. You know?
Additionally, your fuel and your water is really, really, really high consumption. There's no way to slice it in that this is a better engine. At the absolute, absolute, absolute best, which even I'm not going to give it to it because I don't feel it deserves it, it is on par with some of the others. On par. There is no universe where it's better.
You know, it can be used for odd jobs. You know,
it can be used for odd jobs, but it can be used for the right kinds of odd jobs. It can't be used for the right kinds of odd jobs.
Yeah. And that's why we only break out the heavies when the ink.
Yeah. It's not versatile at all.
How would you switch 1218?
You can't.
Like,
You can't maneuver with it. You can't do anything.
You can. Articulation.
Milky, again, I say, prove it.
Articulation doesn't solve the problem that if you're trying to switch out something with a very, very large engine, you're going to have a bad time.
You're switching with an engine that is almost twice the size of, you know, some of the other engines in this fight.
You're going to have to do a lot of things. You need an all-purpose kind of engine. And that's why the Mikados...
Which this is not.
And that's why the Mikados 765 are good candidates. Even, you know, to harken back to Beta Rail, 18 is not necessarily a bad candidate. It's, you know, it's smaller compared to the other ones. But even still, 18, it affords you a
18
lot.
Mm-hmm. 18 I stand by, although I think 18 is on the cusp of being a little bit too small.
Yeah.
She's a light consolidation and not a very fast one at that, and at that a very, very old one.
Yeah.
So I'd say even though it could be, and there could be a case made for it, 18's a little bit too on the light side.
It's a little bit light. You know, you'd be better off doing. Well, hell, you're better off doing what you do with it, and not what I do with it. Which is sort of just perusing from place to place and not running errands. Doing what you can to stay alive, as opposed to, doing what you can for everybody else. You know, and Milky. If you were to go this route, you'd absolutely have to, because you'd need a city to run that engine.
Yeah. And granted, you didn't specify how many people we would have with us instead of buckets.
In the basic scheme of things, you can look at what the zombie train is, and we run it, and we have a little bit of extra with, I think, 30? Just in general, and that's including passengers a lot of the time. You'd have to be doing a lot of scavenging, and you'd probably need other sorts of equipment to help you get the engine fueled and get the engine watered.
Yeah, that's my biggest thing with that, honestly, isn't even the manpower aspect of it. It's that you couldn't find enough resources to run this engine. You can't find the fuel and the water for it and the grease for it. You can't imagine the kind of resources this thing burns through. Yeah. It wasn't built to be particularly efficient. It was built to do what it does. It was built to move things at a medium speed, and it was built to move a lot of it.
No,
and it does that fairly well. And it does that really well, actually. It's a very good design of a locomotive. But in this sort of thing, no. It makes no sense.
Yeah, you're going to get yourself killed with that. Is that, you know...
Going to have...
And so, once again, you know, we've made our judgments elsewhere. And... By a margin, not a very large one, but by a margin, 765 comes out on top, and then the Mikados are right underneath it.
Mm-hmm.
Only because they're afforded a little bit more maneuverability.
Having
a larger engine can be helpful, but having a smaller engine can be helpful as well, and there's a hole in my shirt. This is my Steamtown shirt. I wore my Steamtown shirt today to commemorate Steamtown being Steamtown.
I'm back. What did I miss?
You won.
You missed Weibold ripping into 1218 again. Anyways.
Okay, I'll have to watch this episode.
I don't have anything against 1218. I was getting a little bit annoyed.
What is this?
Yes.
Yeah.
If you prove it. Don't just sit there and, you know, well, that's
no.
Not... Then explain to me how that works. If you can do it, then I'll give it to you. But if not, then shut up.
So I'm gonna list our leaders here then. You know, Kevon, have you got anything stand out about 4501 that you think would place it above Blount?
Not really. It's an older locomotive, so I understand.
Yeah, I just wanted to know because I'm.
It is a good choice though.
Yeah, it's definitely a good solid choice.
I think the only bad choice out of all these is.
God damn!
I'm not gonna say it.
It's too big, Milky.
It's too big.
Huge. I thought you were gonna say 765 because you were going against Jader.
No,
I meant to. I'll do it next week though.
I thought you have to beat Milky next week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, are we doing
don't
that?
Don't beat me.
I don't know, we'll see. Well, you'll kill something else.
Kill SP.
TBA is gonna be sad.
Oh, I'd love that.
Yeah, TBA is gonna be sad because
I don't
wait,
love
boy is MNW powered.
And you don't love TBA, Wible? What the hell?
No.
Oh. What?
Oh.
Jeez.
I said I didn't mean that. I didn't mean that I like him sad.
that's
yes. You're a terrible person.
TBA is gonna be sad. Oh, I'd like that. Why?
We weren't even testing. I'm not happy about that. No.
Well,
that was out of context. I'd be happy to go up against him in locomotive versus. And even that, I said, you know, no, because I don't have this, you know, need to kill anything.
You know, we should do this again at some point, and instead of doing it as harkening back into 2011, or 2012, rather, do it in modern day. So, you know, every year thereabouts, we'll come back and we'll see, okay, what are four engines that, you know, if the world ended right now, what would we run out and get? Yvonne, you'd still be boned.
There's nothing.
What do you mean?
There's nothing
Texas
for
State.
Miles.
They run Bunker C oil.
Oh.
Yeah, there's your problem.
Fun. Well, what about the Grapevine?
They use oil too, I believe.
I was there when he was looking up all these engines and he's like, they all burn oil. I'm so screwed. Anyways,
what will this Texas? Ooh.
Our big air wreck, deep in the heart of Texas.
Texas is singing karaoke about how great Texas is.
Hey, I found
Texas
this.
Texas is singing karaoke about how great Texas is.
Anyways, speaking of... What is this?
I think I found it.
Uh-huh. I mean, heritage equipment.
It looks okay.
I like it.
Yeah.
I quite like it.
Anyways,
yeah.
Speaking of wherever that was from the O Gauge Forum, is that what it is? Yeah.
Yes.
It's time to move on to the last section. Or the second last section, I guess.
I nailed that segue.
Hang on.
What? No, we're not hanging on.
I nailed the segue.
So, Kevon.
See.
What'd you get?
I got Transdim. It is amazing.
Whoa. Oh, I thought he got AIDS.
That too.
Oh. Wow.
Congrats on the sex. Anyways. Using a train's dim, which Kevon has so nicely purchased for use by the group.
Yeah.
We're,
We should have all chipped in.
I'm gonna give him $10 next time I see him. Or, you know, whenever I see him.
Whenever you see
him. Yeah.
Terminus Meetup Part 2.
Part 2.
Yeah,
we
should have. I didn't know you were gonna get that.
Terminus Meetup Part 2. We
soon
pay again. Kevon. Here you go. And in exchange, I'm going to get Rhode Island.
All of Rhode Island. Gonna,
yeah, all of Rhode Island, as if it's so massive. No, yeah.
I think this is the first time that's ever been said.
All of Rhode Island?
No, Rhode Island because it's so massive.
I said as if it's so massive.
Oh, okay.
I was being sarcastic.
I might soon be doing Texas.
Spoiler, so. Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
R.I.P. your computer.
Whip.
Talking about things that are too big for their own good.
R.I.P. my heart.
Yeah. Oh. I'm sorry, I just made a bunch of Texans very angry.
Yep.
There go all the Texan viewers. Bye, Kevon. Yeah.
Bye, Kevon.
The eyes of Texas are upon you.
And to a day.
No, but a Dem of Texas.
Other news, Texas has seceded from the United States.
A Dem of
Texas has seceded from the Union. Thank you, Terminus Podcast.
That's what's in, like, their farewell note. Anyways.
No, fuck you, Terminus Podcast.
A Dem of Texas as a whole would be absolutely massive and oversized because it's trains. Most of the area does not have railroad tracks. So you're just gonna, like, here's some desert.
Here's some
cows.
Moo.
Moo.
And then I'm going to get Rhode Island, and I was like, I'd like to make this easier for Kevon and not select pieces without,
Where is that?
Railroad tracks, and then I was looking over the map of railroad tracks, and the USGS, the U.S. Geological Survey, it does things in big blocks, big chunks.
Yeah.
No single chunk in Rhode Island has no railroad tracks in it.
Flip.
Not because we have a lot of railroad tracks, but because there are so few chunks. It's just kind of obnoxious. Oh, this is where you are, Kevon. I was wondering where you were. It actually lost track. Because he's going through the branch line here, the old main, and I'm like, shouldn't he be way farther? I thought you were way farther down than you were, to be honest.
Oh, no, no.
Yeah. But now I know where you are, because I remember that bridge.
You're taking it slowly.
Beautiful.
With the T1.
It looks beautiful.
Advertising K&L,
the
I
other
guess.
T1. Yeah, we'll talk about that in a minute. After the Iron Horseman Railroad, I think I'm going to take a detour and build Rhode Island and then go back to some, you know, freelance stuff. Like the...
It's your port, whatever it is.
Tamaros Fell and Anaconda Part 2. Yes.
The Tolbrind Peninsula.
Tolbrind
Peninsula. Oh, yeah, that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that.
With the Inner Ermine.
Yes.
The Inner Ermine's gonna be fun.
Oh, yeah.
Fun in inverted commas. I should just build that first and set up portals and just have an obnoxious amount of trains coming through. So that everyone can be like...
That.
So you can experience the chaos immediately.
Mm.
Hey, I would do that. I'd like to have somebody helping me.
Yeah. Maybe Weibold could. Soon.
What? Don't drag me into this.
Hey. What are you... What were we talking about beforehand?
I get you. Okay.
Jesus Christ.
I need to find the thing. Hang on. I'm working, okay.
What are you working on?
Oddly enough, that.
What?
I can't find this section. Okay,
Dem.
I think it is time for me to kiss goodbye to my current trains version. I've had it for,
whoa,
I think basically
for
since
the
it came
longest
out,
time.
Whoa. So I've had it for 4 years now. It has a lot of content that I don't need in it. It has a lot of big roots that I no longer need, and it, in light of the, in light of THC, it in a lot of aspects no longer works. It is in some ways dying and very broken. So,
Kevon, how fast are you going?
I think
I'm
it may be time to look
32.
At getting TS Mac 2.
Woo!
And
I guess
one of the advantages with that would be I'd be able to reincarnate the whole DNRGW narrow gauge division thing, which, thanks to Kevon, I'm currently working on a dumb version of Durango. I'm putting streets out.
I like how it went Shakwad with the what's supposed to be there and what's not. Like, you were building the, building Durango and Silverton, and then the Silverton Northern, and you got Durango and Silverton, part of the San Juan extension, part of the Red Apple line. and no Silverton Northern.
Yep.
I blame trains. I blame trains now. It's all its fault.
Yay.
Once Gavon figures out how to use it like an expert, like an MLG pro, he'll basically just...
If only the track work was better.
Oh my god.
the track work is definitely awful.
The track work is... good.
I
mean, it's near-ish, but it could be a lot better.
Near-ish?
It tried. We'll just say that.
I mean, hey, at least the track is sort of in the right place.
I was surprised that it laid track.
Yeah. The track is nice.
When it's
if
in the
right... If it didn't lay track, then I wouldn't have any interest in it.
Yeah, that's because you said
that. Well, no.
I would have interest. It builds the ground for
me.
I
would. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's the hardest part of the whole thing is, you know, especially when you're modeling something realistic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, like I was doing in Rhode Island, getting the landforms and where everything is relative to one another and, you know, stuff like mountains and stuff. Gracious, is that helpful?
Yeah.
I don't think you could do that otherwise.
That, you know, it eliminates, half the time maybe of building a route?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
The only thing you have to do is, again, like, not, really particular
not
stuff.
Not cut. Necessarily it, you know, gets rid of half the time, but it does allow you to do bigger things without having to worry about doing the mountains of all these, you know, in my example, without having to worry about doing the mountains of all this. It's not necessarily as daunting to take on something, you know, it's a little bit larger. You have the ability to do it because a lot of it is done for you.
Yeah, that bridge, though. Look at that bridge from the top. Look at the shape it has, because it's awkward.
Yeah, the track work is weird.
Because the bridge does not like being a curve. It really, really doesn't.
Nope. I see. Trains isn't working.
Uh-oh.
Oh. We made this far into the podcast.
Don't I know, this is astounding. I'm so glad this worked.
Yeah, I am too.
We'll have to just...
Trains did crash through before the podcast, so...
Yeah.
And now you jinxed it.
Happy you, Crash. Alright, you're heading for Mason Ridge now.
Mason Ridge?
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's called?
Yep.
Whoa. Okay.
Anyways. I think I track marked that line at one point or another. I don't remember.
It's like this.
And the track marks go faulty.
Yay.
Shut up, okay? I'm not happy replacing all those signals. That's what I've been doing, you know.
At least the branch line is okay.
Yeah, the old main is good. Thankfully, because it used dartboards. The dartboards are immune.
Oh boy.
You can't stop them.
That's because they're standard.
Damn right. Anyways. I haven't been to either of my river clubs.
No?
No, I haven't had time. Finals are coming.
What is this?
Yeah, I've got those this week.
Yeah.
I have those in a few weeks.
I had my first final yesterday at 8 p.m.
Rip.
You mean today? Yeah.
Yes.
Also dailies. Yesterday.
Also dailies, yeah. I can't do that right now.
Dailies, I already got mine. Wait, no.
What?
You did, Jader?
You did?
No.
You want to tell me more about your dailies?
Wait. No, I have an outfit.
No, you don't. Moving on.
No, my mom's boyfriend came in and he wanted to see me do some stuff and work on it real
quick.
Of course,
all right. Moving on, you have a point.
Fuck you.
So, what's next?
Doesn't he lose a point because he won at Locomotive Versus technically?
Well,
yes.
No. Because he got this point afterwards. There's no such thing as negative points.
Bullshit.
Alright.
Bullshit.
Also, we need to play some War Thunder after the podcast because...
War Thunder Duels,
hypothetically speaking, I might have a day 6 reward today, and I might get some really cool like boosters and stuff in it.
Mm-hmm. Is that day 6? Whatever. Anyways, not War Thunder podcast.
No.
Hypothetically speaking.
After the podcast.
Hypothetically speaking.
Wyvern vs. Milky.
Oh, jeez. I'll do it.
I'd be up for it.
Anyways, so okay. What's going on in your neck of the woods?
I have a lot of stuff.
Yeah, go.
All right, where do I start? I'll start with the COMRC open house that, that person XCube took me to yesterday. And, you know, he joined, last week, something like that? Yeah, he joined last week. So he was able to take me as a guest to run stuff.
It's not that bad.
What?
Yeah.
Look at what you hate. He's not that bad.
What do you want to
be? He doesn't shut up.
Yeah, neither do we.
Yeah.
I can tolerate you guys because you're not squeaky.
Oh, don't worry. It won't last that long.
No, I can tolerate you guys because you're not squeaky.
What?
And I doubt it.
What?
I'll hang on. Anyway, we got there and let's see what was running. One of the kids that was running his 1218 with like a 30.
Oh my god!
Yeah.
I'm assuming all of the zombies were after him. How long did he last? Please tell us. Please enlighten us.
He was one of them. There's no way he lasted that long. He was one of them.
Oh, he was running for the entire time.
He was running for his life.
Like, I mean, he stopped maybe once or twice because, you know, somebody derailed.
Sucker!
But, or someone who was switching or whatever, but otherwise, he was running the entire time.
Good boy.
Yeah. That's an awesome engine. It has smoke, it's got the,
Yeah.
Is it the BLI one?
Yeah. It's awesome.
Oh, yeah.
On the note of smoke, when I was at the train show these past couple days, I was looking for smoke fluid because I saw an ad in Model Rarity for like holiday flavored and scented smoke fluid, so you could have like gingerbread flavored smoke fluid. I was like, I could send some of that with Ulysses heavyweight coaches and have Johnson be just belching out gingerbread or something of the like.
I'm pretty sure I'm pretty sure smoke is banned at the PN.
Oh,
I know.
Wait, what?
Even if it's like festive like that?
I'm pretty sure because it'll set off people's like asthma or allergies or something. I don't know. It was just like
gingerbread.
I was like, it has smoke, and someone was like, oh, don't do that. You get in trouble. And I was like, okay, well, I turn it off. And I'm not sure about, the Nebula.
If anyone, I'd imagine they're the ones that have the problem with it. They have a problem with everything else.
Well, it's true, but...
Sorry, Nebula.
It's true, but... I don't know. I think they don't do smoke just because they don't have smoke.
Oh, this is the guy.
What was what guy?
He has like a... Not a GoPro, but some little camera that he took to the open house. And yeah. And just pushed it around, recorded some stuff.
Oh, okay. That's a nice looking layout.
Yeah. It's a cool video, too. It's good quality, actually.
Yeah. We have one of these for the PN. I don't know who has
it, though. I'm tempted to get one.
Anyways.
But, it took me to the open house. You know, the kid was running his 1218. There was some guy with the Capital Limited.
Oh, my God.
One of the adult members was running that. And then don't know if he was an adult member or not. Probably not, because I've never seen him there before.
Not in my backyard.
No, but he was running a LNER straight DC LNER V12. I think. Mm. Yeah, V12. And four coaches that he just stole from the Thomas layout.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
And we start talking to him, and turns out he's, I guess, more into British trains. Whoa. Yeah, so we start asking him, Cube starts asking him, okay, what class is Thomas? And then, he's a E2, an E2, blah, 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 blah. And then I'll occasionally jump in and,
Whoa! Oh, Jesus Christ. Hey, K4!
What?
I'm watching the video.
No, it's not a K4, but... One,
it wasn't a K4?
No, one, no Jake, oh.
What was it?
Jake... G5? Yeah, Jake 3 has a M1.
Oh, okay.
Jake 3.
He has an M1, a T1, and a J1.
I just saw, you know, I just got like a second long glimpse of the firebox. It was like, ah, Kenzie.
Little pair.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Ah, La Flange.
Jeez.
C'est la belle paire.
We start, you know, and I would occasionally jump in to, you know, like, correct him, like, you know,
don't
school.
Be that guy.
No, I was just, I'm trying to help. Cause
I'm already that guy, and I don't.
And then,
don't be that guy.
Then, you know, I was walking around.
Don't be like me. I know.
But I was walking around, following my train around the layout, make sure, you know, it didn't derail or anything. And as I passed by where they're sitting and talking, I caught wind of them talking about Shed 17.
I didn't know about this until today.
The guy with the B12 was talking about Shed 17. I'm just like, oh, no.
By the way.
No. What?
I said I'm not linking this.
Yeah, no. Don't. I mean, I haven't seen
it. Don't
look
it up.
I haven't seen it, but he was talking about it, and I've seen some of the guys on FCNN talk about it.
Don't look
it
up.
No.
It's really not that interesting.
It's like Nightmare Thomas.
Nightmare Fuel.
Yeah, I need to put the pictures from my phone. Hold on.
Oh, dear, my paint thing is stuck on. Dang it.
What the heck?
What? Your paint name is stuck?
Mm-hmm. I don't know who's trying to... Alright, but, before we went to the open house, we stopped by his grandparents' house, his grandparents' house to drop off some of the fruit he sold for the... and some other stuff for the FFA fruit sale. Yeah. That's the wrong thing.
Oh, there we
it's outside.
Go.
There is no fruit here, senor.
We got it from Florida.
I am fruit.
Anyway.
I am fruit, specifically in that order. Exclusively in that order.
Anyway, we stopped by his grandfather's house to drop off some of the fruit. And, you know, previously he was telling me about his layout that he has in the basement.
Mm-hmm.
And popsicles, but...
No.
And the dead hookers.
And Tylenol PM.
But I'm posting some pictures of it. And let me just say, probably the most beautiful layout I've ever seen.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
You need to see Dick Alwell's layout.
I think I posted the same pic. No, I...
Let me look.
That's pretty nice. The water's kind of...
Yeah, the water's a little bit green.
Well... Considering the layout's like 50 years old, you got to give.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's all wow. DC and.
Oh wow!
Wow.
I didn't take a picture of it, but
that's
he lifted
painful.
Up. He lifted up the control panel, and I don't think I've ever seen so many wires in one place on a train set.
You haven't
it's
seen our
insane.
Control panel.
Hold on. There's a little downtown scene.
Our control panel will give you epilepsy if you look at it too long.
Oh, no.
We only have one block.
Yeah.
No, it's all.
And you have one of those Spectrum Americans.
Americans.
Oh, we've got one of these at the Nebula.
Yeah, but that control panel lifts up, and you can mess with all the wiring. Good God.
Mm-hmm.
It was insane.
It was ridiculous.
Yes. Are you showing these pictures to the audience?
Yes, I am.
Okay. And then, just a decent picture with a bunch of buildings in it.
That's
the buildings
cool
are really nice. I like the, you know, the detail in all of them.
Yeah.
No, what's awesome is...
What?
His grandfather scratch built every single building on the layout.
Holy cow.
Yeah, so...
That's a lot
and
of buildings.
And still in, like, on a couple shelves and stuff in his basement, and... You know, all that. He has, I think, in total 950 buildings
Holy
that he's built for
Jesus.
The past 50 years.
This guy likes buildings.
He sells them.
Apparently. Yeah.
Oh.
I can understand why.
I'm tempted to buy a few.
Mm-hmm.
Dang it, Hank.
What did Hank do?
He stuck out the signal.
Rip.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You guys, you still have signals.
Yeah.
We're also missing a significant degree of terrain work and stuff.
Well, there was a the picture load, but he had an L1, which I'm gonna build in Gmod.
Why not the boobs, Decapod?
I'll do that too.
I'm doing it. I have that.
No, I've explained this to Cube a lot of times. My list of projects for stuff to build in Gmod is
very long. It's
ridiculous.
The list is long. Too. Sick. The list is long.
Yeah. Here's more buildings.
Good. I wish I had the money for that.
Yeah. No kidding. Or the time.
Yeah.
Same.
Mm-hmm.
I thought somebody was gonna bring something up, but I guess not.
Do I have any other?
Two.
I have more pictures, but I'll see if I can just.
Don't worry, come on. We'll bash your amiibo fetish later.
Yeah.
Here's like a little farm scene type thing.
This is a really well done layout.
Yeah. Oh yeah. It's being 50 years old. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hmm. Like cows. Or yeah, cows. Oh. Or goats or
Are they animated with the little flies?
No.
No.
Worthless.
That'd be amazing though. Bonus points for Tane Cow.
Tane Cow. Anyways, speaking of what?
Yeah, that's it. I have some Gmod and train stuff, but that can wait.
Well, I was gonna say, speaking of Tane Cows, you made some farms for me.
Yes, I did.
And
I did some farms on the Davenport Southern.
Okay. And also, you're going to save the EBT.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because,
you know, actually, you're going to resurrect it after Wyvold killed it.
Wow. I didn't... It wasn't that bad.
Yeah, you did. You killed it.
Devon, I love the whistle on the T1. Like, holy crap.
It was not that bad.
So did that car almost get murdered? Does that crossing not work?
I don't know why... Almost ATLS is weird.
You fools.
Yeah, that one works.
This one works. I mean, it doesn't give people time to actually get out of the way, but
I think the first one and yeah, I need to. I'll mess with those. In Nord.
It's an awkward ATLS situation because of the there's a lot of ways in and out. So
I need to buy the T1s. But
yes,
and I hit a milestone on the Davenport Southern. You can, it's kind of sketchy around Wellston. You can drive from Johnstown to Wellston. It's complete. That line is completely scenic.
Yay! Mm.
So, next run session, do that.
I don't know what I'm doing next run session. Actually,
on the Davenport Southern.
That car just got murdered.
That car just got murdered.
I would say one more Logan sign, but yeah, it's.
There's a bus giving. Never mind.
bus sex.
Kevon, are you trying to stop?
Yes, I
you missed.
No, I didn't. I didn't miss. Kevon. Look at this. I didn't miss.
You're on the main line.
I know.
You suck.
Although, to be fair, the other bus. Two things bus. Would have been on the main line as well. Double bus. I like that billboard.
Tater, why do you have a picture of this?
Trains Road Simulator 2009 billboard.
Picture of what?
Of us going up the river on Pee-wee.
Anyways.
Because Pee-wee floats.
Anyways, what else is going on? Milky, what did you do?
I got the entire Ayahuasca Railroad.
How long is that?
Like about 600 miles.
How long?
Really? That was 600.
I'll double check right now.
I mean, I think I'm doing about 200 miles too, so I can't judge. But
yeah,
it's not 200 continuous miles. It's 200 miles in 7 different directions.
Yeah,
470 miles.
Oh, okay, that's a little bit more up there.
Milky, you are a crazy man. What are you running now?
I know. I'm a crazy man. But the current
guy. Crazy man.
What is that?
But that's about.
Come on, what are those?
It's smaller than the Logan so annoying to this and that
to Douglas.
I kept on.
Douglas.
That's not bad.
Douglas.
Ooh.
Oh, wow. Damn, son.
What?
I'm gonna need that stuff. I'm gonna have to park that in Douglas. Anyways.
And apparently the Alaska Railroad has metal machines.
They'd better have metal machines.
I think they have two. Three? I don't know.
I don't know where they got them from, but they're new.
I like probably the awards.
What's this?
Metal machine.
Oh, they're new. Oh, they look nice.
Yeah. Next
they
team.
They have a sharp paint scheme. They have a sharp paint scheme.
Yeah, they do.
And a good
that.
TV show.
Yeah.
I have a lot. Oh, I love that paint scheme. That paint scheme.
They do pretty good for Standard Gates Railroad. That was the Narrow Gates Railroad.
Yeah.
Just like the Rio Grande.
Except little engines can do big things.
Oh my god.
Insert the Thomas song.
Symbolism!
Symbolism!
Now insert the Thomas Soul Engines can something. I don't know the name of the song.
I don't know. Something really useful engine, something.
Flashback Friday.
And I also got a few other dams. I got the Nevada Northern, Virginia and Truckee, Grand Canyon Railroad connected.
With the ski jump?
Yeah, I made a ski jump off of the Grand Canyon. It's awesome.
You are a crazy man.
I mean, I've made roller coasters.
How do you have the time to do all of these, Mookie?
I don't know.
Because he has no life.
See, I thought I didn't have a life.
Well, you don't either.
I don't think I do.
Hey.
Ooh. Well. Ooh. Wait. Go. No. Come on.
You
go
can
back.
Have a life.
Go back where?
Nah, that's right.
To the other side of the car.
Yes.
Turn the camera.
And I've been making everyone Christmas presents in Gary's mod.
So have I.
I haven't. Yep.
I haven't. I'm not good at
Gary's. I already finished your Christmas present.
Yeah, I finished yours too. Ellis.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, I forgot the Gmod server's down. Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll have to go on Gmod at some point.
Maybe
soon TM. Yeah, exactly.
No, you better stop. On the Iron Horseman server, we're gonna have a, sometime after Christmas, we're gonna have a big gift exchange.
Yeah.
And you better be, because I have your present ready to go.
Yeah, I have yours too.
I have yours, Milky. I need to make TJ. I need to, and I have part of Ogilius's. So I need to finish.
Jader, you said William, and how do we move your props before you knock off? Just saying.
Damn it.
It's okay. I didn't see much, but.
Oh my god, I'm gonna crash the Hank.
Oh my god. Go around him.
And Jader, I only have
Go point, around him. So. Where are you and where is he?
Oh, he's on the other side. Good. Good thing the AI knows how to run left side.
Go down the gorge. Or go down the thing.
Anyways, that's all I have for virtual railroading.
I've got nothing much,
go through the gorge.
Everyone sees the 2 hours of work that I put in every week, so.
Yeah.
Oh, I just.
Well, or at least you have the option to. Anyways. Yeah, I am. I'm doing whatever.
No, I'm starting the Texas State Railroad.
I'm excited for your Rhode Island thing. I think that'll be interesting to see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this new, the DEM technology is by no means new, but it is very new to this group and to us. And it's something that seems to have caught on. So I'll be interested to see
how
the DEM of America.
How we handle it. Everybody will go about it a little bit differently.
What?
That turn.
What turn?
The turn. You could see it turning sideways.
Oh.
What?
Oh.
It was just a bit of wonky track work or something.
I guess.
There's a turn.
Come on.
How fast are you going?
Full speed. 78.
Jesus Christ, Yvonne's limit there through there is 60.
It says 100.
Well, no, now you're in the 100 zone.
Sorry.
Anyways.
Speed.
Anyways. I'm actually trying to work on a... I'm actually trying to work on a Christmas present, so to speak, for... Well, for people outside of this group is really what it boils down to, because you guys kind of have it already. No word on exactly what that is yet, but let's just say it's been asked for.
Yeah.
So...
What?
Anyways, is that all?
Yeah. That's all I got.
That's all I have. All
right.
Hopefully I can release a, like, an alpha version of the Davenport Southern for Christmas for everybody. At least for everyone in the group. It's not ready to go public yet. Soon, TM.
Yeah.
I mean, if I have a dem, you know, a dem for the narrow gauge, that'll save so much time.
Yeah, the dems are going to save everyone here a lot of time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Whee! Yeah.
Hold on.
It's always saving me a whole bunch of time on my loot.
Alright,
so...
Yeah, I need to figure out exactly what I want to do, because terminating things at the edge of the state is not necessarily going to be the easiest thing.
Ugh, because with that cab.
Yeah, it's kind of wonky.
Yeah, it's kind of wonky.
I mean, it works. It says kilometers per hour instead of miles per hour.
What? Oh, ew. Awful.
Yeah.
Get out of here, you.
I blame the walking room.
Scum.
Anyways.
You non-imperial scum. Metric scum.
Maybe next time we'll be able to see a ride through the gorge. Or whatever we're doing next time. Kevon, I'll have to come
soon.
I'll either be creeping on you or creeping on somebody else. Unfortunately, I can't creep on Jader because his computer hates it.
Well, internet.
Yeah.
And my computer hates it.
And
you can't
your,
do it to me because
Mac.
It sucks.
Everyone say it together.
Because
Mac.
Anyways,
I'm a Mac. I'm a PC.
What are you doing? PC?
I can do something. I can't.
What are you doing,
I'm
PC?
Linux.
Oh, I'm just playing some games. Oh, really? Which ones? Oh, you know, all of them.
All of them.
Anyways, first
on that bombshell.
On that bombshell. Actually, I have these.
And on that
I have
bombshell.
These the wrong way around. Excuse me, Milky. You need to get nudged.
Yeah, I know.
Richard Hammond now has a radioactive pee.
What?
What?
Thanks.
Wait, no.
Thanks.
No. What?
And on that bombshell.
And on that bombshell. Kevon?
No. He has a radioactive anus.
Great.
Have you not seen the Top Gear where they go to Chernobyl?
No. You mean Chernobyl?
Yeah.
That's a good episode.
Chernobyl? Wait, why do I have a strike?
For being a terrible person.
I'll take that.
Yeah, you will. All right. Kevon, you get first words.
Oh, I get first words. Maglevs, the future of railroading.
Oh.
Boom.
Not gonna. It was not going to say it.
Yeah. I'm building this.
Already
don't
got
know one, but
I've already
that.
Got one strike for being a terrible person. I'm not gonna go for another.
I mean... Okay. I'd like to say that with Transdem entering the group, we are officially off on the road to Rhode Island.
And realism.
Realism.
Okay. I like that one more.
Yeah.
There's a song for this one, for the record.
Oh, whoever's next on the thing? Oh, it's me.
That's you.
I was frozen today.
Oh.
Oh no, what is this? Wow.
Brr.
Who's next? Jaden. Art. Pretty sure it's Jader.
Okay, go ahead.
Jader.
Jader.
Jader's dead.
Jader. Wakey wakey. Oh.
Okay. Anyways, and Milky?
Transdem is the effect.
Yay.
So that is going to be something new and exciting for the Terminus podcast.
Yay.
And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Next podcast, we'll be celebrating the return of the Iron Horseman Chronicles. See you in 2 weeks.
See ya. Almost Merry Christmas.
Chaga chaga.
I forgot about that.